Ahoy!
Ahoy!
Yo-ho! Yar! Hello! Ahoy! Oh my gosh, this is in the shot. Let's get this out of here. Oh, so many exciting things going on. Welcome to the Nicer Roundtable live stream of Sea of Legends. Look, it's on the table, and I can't tell you, like, normally, I don't want to say I feign excitement for things. I try to keep things up and peppy, but this is, what you're reading from me here is genuine, legit excitement, yes. Because... yeah, this is just one of the most fun games that I've played in the entire year. And I want to start off with a... by the way, hello, Slivers in chat. Glad you could join us. Hopefully more can pop in. I just want to start off with a disclaimer, I guess is the best way to put it.
A disclaimer.
So Guildhall Studios created this game, Sea of Legends, a few years ago. It was on Kickstarter, and I thought, that looks fantastic. And I love pirate games, and I'm going to back that. And then I forgot about it. Life got in the way. And then it came and it went, and I got very, very sad, because I thought, oh, shoot, I really wanted to be a part of that. And then maybe a couple of years, I don't know what the gap was, a couple of years later, as you know, I do contribute from time to time to the Rotter Runs Through channel, and Guildhall Studios commissioned me to make a video for their game, because there's a little bit of player versus player action going on in it, and
well,
that's really not Rotto's bag, so whenever he encounters a mechanic that he's not really on side with, he hands it over to one of his associates, and I'm one of his associates. Mm-hmm. So I was thrilled when the company said, hey, you know, can you make a how to play video for Sea of Legends. I was like, heck yes. So they sent it, and they had done a first expansion and kickstarted that, and when they sent this game, I was like, hey, where's the first expansion? Unfortunately, it was completely sold out. They didn't have any more left to send. I was like, okay, that's okay. I'll just
be sad forever.
I'll just see what I can do with the with the base game. And all in the video, if you saw the how to play video on the channel, on Rado's channel, you saw that I talked about some of the extra stuff that's in the expansion. And the reason they wanted video commission for this one is because they have a second expansion. Now, if this turns out to be your thing, and I'm hoping to convince you that if you like pirate games and you like sandbox games, it will be your thing. This Kickstarter is live for precisely 2 more days. I think this morning it was at 61 hours and counting down. So it's
not that you're counting.
I'm excited about it. They funded like within seconds, of course, right? They just blew it out of the water. They had a bunch of stretch goals. They made every single last one of them. The stretch goals are awesome. One of the things that you'll see in this game is there are different non-player character factions that you choose, and so each expansion has a bunch of extra factions, and they actually like had people vote for one, and they designed one and designed all the art, and they designed the minis they just revealed today for the extra faction they put like during the campaign.
Oh.
I'm not going to tell you what
so
it is, but spoiler alert, it's a gigantic whale and it's super cool. So I'm over the moon about all of this stuff.
Ruining surprises.
I know, but check out the link to the Kickstarter, by the way. Please go follow, go take a look as we're playing. I love pirate games, and if you know from the channel, you watch my Find Them Fun series, you know that my absolute favorite pirate game of all time is Merchants and Marauders, or was Merchants and Marauders. Now,
I was going to say,
there were some deep mechanical gameplay flaws with Merchants and Marauders, but at the time, there just weren't any games that solved those problems.
It was the most you could... the game where you could most feel like you were actually doing piratey things.
I agree. It was the most pirate game available.
That's why.
But you know what? Games evolve, and the bold claim I've been making about this game, Sea of Legends. Now, hear me clearly. If you dig Merchants and Marauders, this game fixes Merchants and Marauders.
I think so.
It takes the problem with that game. Cheryl's just very vainly worried about...
No, this is slipping. It's slipping.
Oh my gosh, they might know that you're not an actual pirate.
They're going to know.
Oh my gosh, they mustn't know.
I can feel it. So eventually, it's not going to be on.
That's fine. Yeah, just tear it off and then just jump on the mainsails with your sword and do the whole swashbuckle.
I'm adventuring it.
Exactly. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. This game fixes what went wrong with Merchants Marauders. And what went wrong with Merchants Marauders, there were a few things, but I think the biggest thing was that you could take a few different actions, and one of them was this port action. You'd sail into port, and then you do port things. And the port things, there are like 17 sub-actions. So whenever anybody would announce, oh, I'm going to port, everybody would be like, oh my god, time to go make a sandwich, this is the worst, right? And just people would wait around for like 5, 10, 15 minutes while somebody completed all their port actions.
It could be like 15 minutes.
What this game does to fix that issue is it just simplifies everything wonderfully. There are these different sea zones. You sail your little either ship or figure to the different sea zones, and the port actions are all still there. It's all the same stuff that you can do in Merchants and Marauders. You can listen for rumors about legendary loot. You can hire a crew. You can buy a new ship and fix your ship, all that sort of stuff, except they've split it out. So if you want to go to the tavern, you can only go to the tavern at a place that has a tavern icon. If you want to bury treasure, you can do that in Nassau, but you can't do it in Smuggler's Cove because that's where you're buying a ship. You can go to the tavern in St. John. You got to hire a crew down in Bridgetown. So brilliant fix, brilliant, elegant, simple fix to it. It's really cool.
Now, it's much better.
The other game that I would say vies for my attention for best pirate game of all time, just recently finished its Kickstarter campaign. That was Dead Reckoning. And we just played that on the... We played both of these games on the weekend.
Yes.
We had an anniversary, 20th wedding anniversary retreat. And we played both of them at this little retreat. And I still like Dead Reckoning. I like it very, very much. Now, are you a Dead Reckoning pirate game kind of person or a Sea of Legends pirate game kind of person? Let me try to break down the differences for you. First of all, for some people, an absolute deal breaker is app-based games, and Sea of Legends is an app-based game. So if you're the type of person to say, no, never apps, then automatically not for you. I think that that is a rash decision, and I think that Guildhall Studios has made a number of assurances on their website. So they say, like, yeah, it's app-based, but for one thing, this is coming from me, not from them, but they have it on Google devices, Google mobile devices, they have it on Apple mobile devices, and they have a PC version. So as soon as they said, we've got a PC version, I'm like, oh, it's no problem. Mm-hmm. Because I'm like, I'm still running... The whole worry is that, I don't know if you know this, if you put something in the Apple App Store, and then they make changes... This is what happened to me. They come back to you and they say, oh, you got to, like, at one point they changed it so the entire format of the phone was different. So like, oh, you got to go upscale all the graphics in your game or we'll take it out of the App Store. It's like, what? I don't have the time or money to do that. That's crazy. And then they charge you a fee to have your game on the App Store every single year. You got to pay $100 or something. So if that fee lapses or you don't want to put in the effort to updating your software, they just yank it from the store. So that's the real worry with something on a mobile device. Now, it's on PC. Don't worry about it. Like, I'm still running stuff. Like, I'm running DOS stuff on my PC from, like, 1983. So once it's on PC, I think all bets are off. You don't have to worry about the app going away. But what they say on their website, as far as assurances go, is they say, hey, if we ever go belly up and we're out of business, we'll just release the code and you can do with it what you want. And I thought, well, that's pretty hot. I like that. So if you're worried about the app, now the one thing that I do think is legit about worrying about the app is that apps don't always work the way we want them to. They have bugs in them. And the team at Guildhall Studios has been working very hard to do a version 2 of the app that we've been test piloting and submitting bugs for. It is buggy, I will warn you, and I will warn you that it might be buggy during this very gameplay. What kind of bugs, you ask? Well, it's the kind of thing where, like, I'll get an item, Cheryl will steal it from me, and then the app will tell me, what would you like to do with the item? I'm like, well, I don't know, she has it. So it's that kind of thing. It doesn't always track items very faithfully. It sometimes does goofy stuff where it's like...
Well, there isn't even a way to update it that it got stolen, which there should
be. Yeah, you can't tell the app. You can't tell the app, listen, computer, this is what's happening. And then it'll do stuff like, to make this decision in the app, you have to pay 2 gold. And so you do, and they're like, congratulations, you earn 2 gold. And you're like, well, what was the point of that? So it doesn't always track the sort of risk-reward kind of thing very well. They'll make you pay a reward that they then hand back to you. So a couple of goofy things like that. And then only one time did we have a really severe, serious one where we couldn't continue. It didn't pooch our game. We just had to choose option B instead of option A, but I'll just put it out there. It's not the most perfect app, but they're working on it. Okay.
You can work around it.
Enough yapping. Welcome. Yes. Who are we saying hi? Hi, DJ Mark V. Hey, Dr. Three. But both of you joining us from the UK, right?
No, you keep getting it wrong.
Say hi to Mick for me. all right.
Were you joking just now?
Hola, yes. Okay. Hola, says DJ Mark V. And asks how we're all doing. I'm on Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag kind of pirate game. Oh, you... Ooh. Yes. Now, Cheryl is an Assassin's Creed gamer. She has never played Black Flag.
I have not.
You played the Greek one and the Egyptian one, I think, right? Yeah.
And I've not finished
Not either. Finished either
They're
of them.
They're too big.
There's too many side quests. Hope that light isn't casting too much glare. Here's what I've done to make this gameplay go better. I took the usually straight down overhead camera and I angled it a bit. So if I lean forward, you'll see my head come into the shot. I'm going to try not to do that. But the reason I did that, is because, now you got to understand, I'm not a minis guy. I'm not a guy who freaks out whenever a game has minis. Unless the minis are really, really, really good. And there's only like one or two other board games where I thought the minis were really, really, really good. Monumental was one where I was just blown away by the sculpts on those minis. And this is the other. The minis are awesome. This is Cheryl's captain. His name is Tun. He's like a big, like Pacific Islander, muscly guy, and he gets extra attacks. This is my guy. His name is Cesare. I hope if he's Italian, then you say it, Cesare. He's like a Roman Catholic cardinal kind of guy. The reason that they're gray is because we haven't painted them yet. The reason we haven't painted them yet is because I was working on the how to play and I didn't want to mess them up with any botched paint jobs. But we're dying. We're dying to paint these minis. And if you don't think these are too impressive, wait until you see the big boss minis that come out later in the game. They'll blow your mind. And the whale that they just designed for the Kickstarter campaign is some of these minis are absolutely absurd. They're minis, right? They're very, very large. But the whale one is, they showed a mock-up of it.
Is it bigger than this guy?
Yeah, it's way bigger than that guy. They can't see that guy, so he's off camera.
Well,
but
he's secrets for
he's
later.
He's secrets. He'll come out later.
Yeah.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Attack the Three Buddhas from Maryland. Yes, I know.
Dare you to paint it?
Dare you? I will. You know what? Oh, that's Guildhall Studios. Welcome, Guildhall Studios. Maybe that's Michael. I've been chatting with Michael on their Discord server. The last thing I'll say before we start playing is, man, oh man, I thought so they released different factions. So they had a first expansion and a second expansion, which is the one you can find on Kickstarter now. There's the address. And in the first expansion, they had a faction that was everybody's made of water. Like usually the factions have kind of a couple of grunt minis and then a big boss. So the grunts in that faction were these little water foxes, and the big boss is this witch who's encapsulated by this massive water bear persona, and he looks amazing and ferocious and cool. And then in the most recent expansion that they've kickstarted right now, you can see that by following this link, they have the Cursed Souls faction, which is like a Flying Dutchman themed thing, so everybody's a ghost. And I thought, you know what, I make things for board games, and I have this series, this maker series called Bits Please. Obligatory.
Bits Please! Oh no! Oh no!
So there are a few things that I'd love to make for this game, and the one thing I was fantasizing about was, once I get my hands on that water bear Allura minifig, and once Cheryl upgrades her phone to one that has LiDAR, that's where you can do 3D scanning, I thought, oh man, I can't wait to take the phone and like 3D scan that mini so that I can get the model or rough approximation, whatever the phone does, and then I can print that out in translucent resin so that I can have like a see-through water bear. I thought, oh, that would be so cool. And I thought, oh my gosh, you could do that with the ghosts too. You could make the water ones blue, you can make the ghost green. Wouldn't that be cool? And then I was hanging out on Guildhall Studios Discord, and I thought, man, why don't I just ask them to do that? Save me a whole lot of work. So I brought the suggestion up to them, and I thought they're never going to do it with the one that they've already printed. Like Allura, the Sea Kevin is already out in the first expansion. That ship, forgive the pun, that ship has sailed. But maybe they can do it with the ghosts. So then they took the idea and ran with it. They're doing it with the ghosts. So if you back this thing, you're going to get these green, translucent, Flying Dutchman, Cursed Soul, ghost pirates. And it looks wicked. I just have to say, the mock-ups look amazing. And then, to my absolute shock and surprise and delight, they're like, oh, by the way, we're doing it to the Sea Coven too. I was like, oh my gosh! I haven't fanboy geeked out over a game in a very long time like this.
It's true.
I'm just like, I'm a total nerd for Sea of Legends. I don't apologize for it. Let's play this game. Let's do it. You're going to see a couple of things here that if you own the base game, and please sound off in the chat. I'd like to know if you have the base game. Let me just catch up and read. Oh, by the way, if you want to see some amazing paint jobs, go look up Sea of Legends Painted Minis and some of the paint jobs people have done. Quetzalcoat, the big feathered serpent.
The one you showed me.
Is just, incredible. It looks amazing painted. They all look, oh, they're so good. We can't wait. right. What am I catching up to? I've got two games of Obsession. I'm worried this game is too many. No, buy more games. Next question.
Too many?
Too many? No, too many. I've got two games of Obsession. Like, on the go, or what are we even talking about? I've only played it once, says DJ McVie. Did you enjoy it? Didn't enjoy it? Guildhall Studio says, bet. Sorry to undermine your big project. Yeah, I've got other big projects that I'd like to tell you about, Guildhall Studios, for this game that I'm very excited about. Oh, good, cool. Aerodell is here and says, Sea of Legends, woo. So we have a couple things that you might not have if you own the base game. This is one of them. These are just like in, this is a co-op competitive game, and you might know from co-op games, one of the things you do is there's like a big deck of bad stuff, and you usually draw a card, and it's like, oh, now there's a million viruses on the board, and everybody's dead, right? So that's like a common thing in co-op games. This is a co-op competitive game, so it's co-op in that you're trying to beat the bad guys, but you're trying to beat them selfishly so that you can then win the game.
Yes.
It's possible for the bad guys to win the game. Nobody wants that to happen.
No.
So one of the things that they sent that's in the new expansion are these Calm Sea cards. So it says, you know, when you draw one, nothing happens. So my question to you, Cher, these are for babies, basically sissy crybabies who don't like hard games. How many of these Calm Seas cards would you like to put in the event deck?
My question to you is, how many do we usually play with?
We usually play with zero, sucka, so forget that. See you later, Calm Seas. You're out of here. We're going hardcore mode.
Are you a pirate, Ryan?
I am indeed
a
pirate.
There we go.
For the first five times we played this game, we played it wrong, and we played it on accidental baby mode. Now that we're on hard mode, the game is way harder, but I'll point that change out to you. So there's our event deck ready to rumble. There are a bunch of different factions to choose from. You get four factions to choose from in the base game. You always play with the Spanish Armada. Please bring out a Spanish Armada ship. There it is. It'll go on the board in a second, but it's this little boat. And the reason you always play with the Spanish Armada is because it kind of acts like that French snail from Finding Nemo that cleans up the tank, you know, it eats all the algae and stuff. So usually a lot of factions like to run around the Caribbean staking their claim on different ports, and the Spanish Armada goes around cleaning up those flags. It's neat because there's a whole turn, as you'll see with the bad guys, where you can actually make them attack each other. So if you're really having a hard time with bad guys, you can actually make them, it's a bit of a puzzle to make them fight each other and clear up the Caribbean a little bit. So there's the Spanish Armada. You always play with them, and then you get to choose two more factions. Now, I will show you one of the figures from the French faction. So this is just a prototype version of the French faction. I'll actually put it on my side camera here so you can see. So he's like a little dandy Frenchman with his little rifle. Oh, who's following? Thank you so much for the follow. Angelkel.
We can't see that.
Anglakel. That's not Bob Kell, is it? That would be amazing.
Really,
I should mention Bob Kell, too. I'll mention Bob Kell in a second after I finish wiggling this mini around. Guildhall Studios is now following on Twitch. Thank you so much for the follow. So this is they just did this on like a resin printer, so this isn't what the final quality will look like, but this is what one of the French guys looks like. I won't show you the big bad for the French faction, but I will say, thank you, Klong Hopper, who can't see this because you're on YouTube. I will say, it is Michael, by the way. Anglic Hell is Michael, by the way. Okay, cool. Good to see you, Michael. I'm glad you could join us. And Guildhall Studios, is that Angel, maybe? I don't know. You can tell. You don't have to reveal yourself. We can stay anonymous here. That's totally cool. Over on my board, I've got a few things going on. I've got my captain, Cesare. That's his captain card. All the captains have powers. I've got my three crew. Everybody starts with the same basic three crew. Everybody starts with a piddling little ship that can't do much. And this isn't really part of my player display, but these are the cards for all the bad guys, and it tracks all the stats for them so that when we start fighting them and they start fighting each other, we know how strong they are. We know what they do. So the Tarrasque, as you'll see, is a gigantic lion turtle monster thing with a floating port on its back, and it's going to eventually enter the board, perhaps sooner than later, and it's going to float around and do stuff. So this is it. It's calm right now, so it's not going to attack too many people, which is great. And this is the other French faction. So this is all part of the new Vengeance of the Empire's expansion. Kickstarter, there you go, there's the link. We have chosen, so you don't choose the Spanish Galleon, but we've chosen to stock this game with the Atlantean Usurpers. So what's going on with them is that they have a king, who you'll see anon, who's riding a gigantic goldfish with treasure, and the idea here is, I guess, his followers have accused him of going completely nuts, and he's running around the Caribbean floating on this giant goldfish, giving away all the Atlantean treasures. And the Atlanteans don't like that. So the Atlanteans are trying to kill him. So he can take 3 wounds. And once he takes 3 wounds, the Atlantean usurpers win the game and the rest of us don't. Unless we're allied with him. And there is a way to take adventures and ally with the Atlantean usurpers. Mm-hmm. The Tarasque shows up once the Frenchmen put their first flag on a port. And then we'll roam the Caribbean. And once all the flags are gone, the Tarasque just gets stronger and stronger and stronger. You can take over ports in this game. You can take over the Tarasque just like any port. And then once all the flags are gone, we're going to flip this card. The Tarasque is going to become enraged and then just like charge like a locomotive to Tortuga. And if the enraged Tarasque reaches Tortuga, we lose and the bad guys win, unless we're allied with the French.
Right.
So that's how that all goes. And so I'll be tracking the stats up here. These two spots are for my rival and my lover. So there's this whole deck of them. There's, I believe, 20 of them. You shuffle up, and at the top of the game, you deal 3 out to people. And the reason why I didn't have this set up at the beginning was because I wanted you to see this process and how it goes, so you see kind of how the game works. So I'm going to shuffle these up and give them. And one of the things I like about this game is that these 20 characters, characters within the app talk about the other characters in this 20-character deck. They show up, and they're doing things in the Caribbean, and it's like it has just a life of its own, and that's, I don't know, it's just super cool. I really like it. What am I missing here? I now regret not backing this game way back the first time around. Oh yeah, Oberon. So Oberon went and chased down a copy, a previously played copy, I believe, and has played it. And I believe, Oberon, you're a believer, right? You like it.
It's a good game. Let me know.
Okay, so you deal out 3 of those cards.
Take them.
They're double-sided. One has lovers on it, and they flip them, and they become rivals. So I'm just going to go over to my little corner here, and we're going to take a look at who we've got. We can be rivals with Axe Fist, Maria, or Nasir. Or we can have them as lovers. So I've described this game as queer as hell, so it doesn't really matter, you know, whether what sex your captain is or how your captain swings, because, like, pirates are swinging every which way but loose in this game. So I think I'm going to choose Axe Fist as my lover for this game, because I've never done that before. And I think, did you have Maria as your rival last time, or your lover?
My lover.
Your lover. I'm going to go Maria as my rival. So now the lovers and the rivals all have powers, abilities, and there's 3 down the card. And right off the top of the game, you put this little token on 1 for your lover and 1 for your rival. The rival's going to get stronger and mess you up as you go, and the lover's going to get stronger and help you as you go. I should just familiarize myself with what my lover actually does. So Axe Fist is a dude with a gun monkey on his back. That's another thing I'll say, just if you're trying to figure out if this game is for you, it's not serious. All right, so Dead Reckoning is much more the serious pirate game, although they have introduced ghosts and other supernatural elements. This one is right goofy, and that's not quite Monkey Island level goofy, but it approaches that. There's a farting contest in the game, and I'm sure you don't actually have to fart, because really that would be unfair. I'd win every single time, but I'm sure that was inspired by maybe like the spitting contest for Monkey Island 2. All right, so for every rose assigned, gain strength. Ooh, very good, because Cesare's not really a strong character. Slap on the wrist. My rival says, if you roll 1 or more daggers, lose 1 strength. Uh-oh, these two counteract each other. Okay. So you can go on adventures, as we'll see, to make your lover stronger and your rival less strong. Are we asking questions here? Calm Sea cards are new cards that can slow down the ramp up the NPC factions. That's true. They're totally optional, and players can decide during setup if they wish to include them. Yes, and we wished not to include them. But yeah, so it's an easier mode. So you can put, like, there are 3 of them, and usually you get 9 event cards in the game, so you can put as many Calm Sea cards, up to 3, as you want in there. And there's, when you have 3, it's like 1 per faction. And they've designed it so hopefully... Now, I haven't tried the game solo, but it's supposed to scale with more players. So when you're playing with only 2 players, you put the 1 to 2 player cards in there. When you're playing with a bigger crew, you put the 3 to 4 player cards in the event deck. Cool. I guess you guys are just asking Guildhall some questions about the game. We lucked into a base game locally after Gen Con. Super fun. Can't wait for the expansion. I know. I'm jacked. It's very exciting. It's very exciting. By the way, I should also mention, as part of disclosure, Guildhall Studios is not paying us to do this live stream whatsoever. This is totally out of passion for the game and the goodness of our hearts. And I'd be lying if I said that we didn't beg them for a copy this morning because I absolutely did. I absolutely did. I'm not saying that if they say no, I won't absolutely buy it. But I'm just saying, I'm putting all the chips on the table. We did ask. But here we go. All right, right. Okay. So have you chosen your lover and your rival?
I have.
Who you got?
Two I haven't had before. So Maru will be the lover and Jules is the rival.
Look at that. Okay. Yeah. Ready to rumble.
So you can take Isabella.
Ahoy, Omelette. Good to see you. Oh, no. Oh, man overboard.
Lost forever.
Man overboard. Oh, this is one other thing I should point out. If you have the base game, there are a couple of misprints on cards. So the card that you get, like the player guide that you get, was misprinted. And I think a couple of characters are misprinted. Isabelle is one of them. If you back this most recent expansion, then for the low, low cost of free plus shipping, they'll give you a reprint pack fixing any of the errors. So one of the errors is on Isabella. Her ability lets you roll more dice, but one of the hard and fast rules in the game is when you're rolling in combat, once you decide how many dice you get through various card effects and whatever, you don't get any more. Once you roll, that's it. That's your roll. So that kind of like didn't work, and people were like, well, what's going on? So they fixed her, and it's free to you if you're a not first-time backer of the project. Cool, cool, cool. Are you ready?
They're saying there's something going on with my camera.
Oh, is there?
There's a red circle and a red square.
Oh, yeah. All you got to do is tap the screen and that'll go away. Yeah, there you go. Hey, look.
There's still a red square, but...
Is there?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, for us, I guess. Yeah. So we know it's active. Okay, cool. Yeah,
cool. Thank you very much. All right. Ready to go? We got to play Rock, Paper, Rapier. This is the pirate version. Ready? One, two, three. Yeah. All right, I win. I'm first. Okay, so I get the start player clock. Okay. Each captain has a starting position, and you also have to take these little tokens that indicate where your lover and your rival begin. So my lover is Axe Fist, and he starts in Claw Bay, and Maria starts in Havana. So... Havana. You'd think I'd memorize the map by now for the amount that we've played. Right. Lover in Claw Bay down here.
Hmm. My lover also is in Claw Bay. How convenient for me. And very nice. Thieves Landing.
Where's Thieves Landing?
Up here.
Good.
Very good.
Good. All on there. Cool. Now what you got to do is if you were playing the home version of the game, you got to go and you have to launch the app. So this is what you could be playing on your phone or your PC. So we'll add who's in here and who's in here while we're playing Captain Tun start, and we are playing Cesare. Where is he? Right there. Bazoom. And that's good. Let's go. Let's play. And then you have to tell the app a download data. Oh yes, this is new because they've recently done an update. I tried to download everything I needed to, but here we go.
Can they see this?
I hope they can. Oh my god. Have I been talking this entire time and you can't hear me? Is that what you're saying? That's super embarrassing. I've said so much important stuff. Hold on. Let me go add the sound source to it and then correct. Oh my god, that's what you're saying. Thank you for talk about... I made a deal about the bug being appy. Man, my live stream is buggy. Hold on. Okay. Thank you very much. I'll add the sound source. It'll be a bit of clicking around and then we'll get it going. Hopefully now you can hear me. Please let me know in the chat if you're seeing the app and you can hear me. I'm very sorry about that. This is kind of a new thing. This is the first time I've tried this, so... Oh, how embarrassing.
Okay, yes.
Oh, good.
Thank goodness.
And am I going to put the audio input capture from the computer as well? Oh, you should already be able to hear it. Great, great, great. What I was trying to say, what I was trying to say was, well, you saw me do it. You picked the lover and the rival for your characters, and then you hit go. And this is a new thing in version 2 of the app, where everybody, normally you just charge into gameplay, but now everybody gets a bit of a prologue that sort of maybe sets the stage for them possibly being friends with one or the other of the factions or enemies. Let's see. Let's see what happens to Captain Tan. So the idea is...
Well, your turn first, isn't it?
Well, this is the prologue. It doesn't matter. You can do the prologue in any order you want. Right. Here we go.
Okay,
here we go. Of course, you have to read it with voices. All right, Cheryl. You didn't mean to steal from that noble. Or at least you didn't mean to get caught. But now you're cooling your heels in jail. They even took your flintlock pistol. Just as you're about to doze off, the end of the pickaxe busts through the wall. In peeks a mystical noblewoman with white eyes. She claps her hands loudly. Evening, she says. I am Karamala the Vizarine, and I'd like your help. Your options are, you're not leaving without your flintlock pistol, or it's time to go. Quickly.
Get out of here.
Okay. You and Karamala skedaddle, leaving your trusty flintlock pistol behind. It's not worth your head. Chin's fire, she says. The French Empire has the worst prison. I couldn't agree more. Oh, what does Tun sound like?
I don't know.
He's a big thuggy guy, so I couldn't agree more, you say. I'll do him like that for the rest of the game. Now, about that help. The Atlantean usurpers need assistance building a citadel in Havana. Don't worry, the rewards will be plentiful.
Well, you say, I do need a new weapon.
I'll get a replacement for you before we weigh anchor. Now, we've got a stop to make, Karamala says. A ghost is disrupting the Atlantean usurper's lumber supply in Cartagena. Let's sail and put this alleged specter to rest. So then you read the results. And it's all good, by the way. So I have played... I'm just going to yap at you for just a second. I've played other... Oh my god, I gotta... Let me just... You know what? If I don't turn that off, it'll happen every single time I switch. So let me... Give me 2...
Oh.
Phew, that was a close one. I've played other story-based games where it's like you have one of two choices to make, and if you make you choose option A, you get 15 gold, and you choose option B, and a character like kicks you in the head, and you die, and you lose all your stuff. This isn't like that. The result of every story, every choice you make, is positive. It gets you something. It always gets you a reward. So that I find is very encouraging and good about the game. So let me just go back to the app here. So what Cheryl gets is Karamala will remember this favor. The app actually sets variables so that if you're good to characters, they'll remember you later on. Karamala's, you get her legendary crew card from the deck, and your adventure token goes in Cartagena. So, oh my god, Bits, please came back up. Hold on, I'm gonna put it to rest. This is terrible.
There. Okay,
let's see if
forever?
It comes back. Let's see if it comes back. We'll try one more time. This is shockingly embarrassing. Okay. Whoa.
It's gone.
Okay.
Okay, we're better.
We've reached an easy piece with Bits, please. Okay, so all of the bad guy factions, or I shouldn't say bad guy, because they're not necessarily all bad, especially if you become friends with them. But they all have a deck full of loot and stuff like that, so we're going to find Karamala, who's going to be a legendary crew member. Legendary crew, Karamala. There she is. So Cheryl gets that. And so Cheryl has 3 crew members. Point to your boat there, Cheryl, and your crew capacity on your boat.
Here is my boat, and I can have 4 crew.
Now, you have 4 crew, but here's the cool thing about legendary crew members. They don't count against your crew limit. And your lover and your rival aren't crew either. So Cheryl doesn't actually have 6 crew. Cheryl has 3 crew. Yeah, cool. All right, good. And now, c'est moi, it's my turn, so we're going to say continue on the app, and then you can read my story. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, you got to read it good, though.
I don't do as well as you do, but okay. Let's try. Okay. Me?
Yes.
Okay. Why do you keep moving it?
We can see it beyond the camera.
Oh, okay. I can see it. Okay. You're drinking grog with Axe Fist at the local tavern when you hear a voice at the bar. The speaker is a brazen nobleman with fabulous clothing.
Ooh, fabulous.
Karamala is undermining the whole French Empire, yeah, he declares.
We can't have that. Well, he's obviously French, so we need a French voice on that.
I can't. We need to offend everybody.
No, we need... If we don't get out of here without offending from some French people, we'll have done the job wrong. No, let's go. Let's go with the French accent. Let's go.
That's Dumas the Chevalier.
Dumas the Chevalier.
Chevalier, sorry. The axe whispers.
Oh, he was whispering. He messed whispers, that up. Yeah, I know. He's got to whisper. Okay, go.
Okay. We should offer to take care of this, Carmala. I bet...
No, we should offer to take care of this Caramala. Like, oh. Yes, they're gonna...
We should offer to take care of this Caramala.
Yes.
I'll bet he rewards us handsomely.
Oh, I bet he will.
What offer to Shanghai, Caramala, you ask?
No.
What?
What? Offer to Shanghai, Caramala?
Okay, I'm reading this. I'm feeling like I'm on, like...
You know, you'll never make it in community theater unless... Unless you nail these reads.
That's like giving me social anxiety. Cool. Okay. I was thinking of humiliating her so she becomes the laughingstock of the Caribbean, he says, casting a suspicious glance to Biscuit. But by all means, let us use brute force instead.
Offer to kidnap Caramala or offer to publicly humiliate Caramala.
Yeah.
I want to kidnap her. She's your crew member. I want to get rid of her.
Okay. You walk up to Dumas, and tap him on the shoulder. Couldn't help overhearing that you've got a problem, you say. Me and my crew, we relocate things. Things that others don't want to relocate, if you catch my meaning. Maybe we could relocate this Caramala if you're having trouble with. This Caramala you're having trouble with. Dumas strokes his short beard.
I can't. Let's go. You're doing it.
You're offering to kidnap Caramala? I see you catch my meaning, you reply. He waggles his eyebrows. Caramala runs with Ton, and a little bird told me where Ton will be sailing.
Ton, that's you. That's your name. Ton. Yeah.
Ton. Let's sail there and see... Can you stop moving? I can't read it. Okay. Moving it. Let's sail there and seize Caramala, he tells you. Results. So Dumas will remember your favor.
Yeah,
I get Dumas. You gain the legendary crew card. Yes, his. Place your captain adventure in... On Captain Ton's card. Ton. Why do I keep saying Ton?
Because I thought it was Ton 2, or Ton 2. And maybe that's why. I asked Guildhall Studio, and they told me that they say it Ton, so Ton. I'm pronouncing it Ton now.
And then you must be in... To go to your Captain Adventure, you must be in my region.
Mm-hmm.
So I, like, travel with your...
Super good.
Captain Adventure token?
Yeah, because, so now I have to go kidnap Caramala from you. So what I do is I take my Captain Adventure token, which is here, and I put it on your Captain card. Sorry, that's yours. I put it on your Captain card. Where's my Captain Adventure token? Put it on your Captain card.
Yeah.
So put it on your Captain card. Yeah, and then if I want to continue my Captain Adventure, I have to go to wherever you are and do that.
Yeah, okay, come.
Yeah, and I also go to the...
I really like her, so you better take her.
I get Captain Dumas, right? Out of the French deck. Is that what I said? Yeah. Not Captain Dumas. Just Dumas. Where is he? Celeste Dumas. There he is. Okay, look at him. Oh my gosh, he's so handsome. So handsome. Let's put him on there. Now, I'm going to quickly run out of room for my crew, so I'm just going to sort of smack dab him right here. We also start with 8 gold, by the way. Dumas exhausts to gain 1 bonus die for every 2 musketeers in play. So the stronger the French get, or the more populous the French get, the stronger Dumas is for me. Looks good.
Yeah.
We could hear you if you were speaking distant seagull. I was for a little bit. So you'll never hear it again. Won't happen. Good. So much pressure, says.
Yeah, he does put pressure.
All right, Captain Dumbass. Now. don't impugn Dumas. That's my guy. All right.
Well,
so
please do.
On the first player, that means Cheryl gets to take the Spanish Armada galleon and put it somewhere in an empty sea zone where there is no port. And it's going to go there. We made the mistake a few... And Cheryl, by the way, is sitting right here. I made the mistake a couple of games ago of killing... Like, sinking the Spanish galleon right away. Because the Spanish are really weak off the top of the game. And that was, especially playing against the French, the worst idea. And maybe you'll see why as we play.
Died in, like, 3 rounds.
Here's what we do. You get 2 moving points with your baby ship. Boom. You look at the sails. That's 2 moving points you can move before or after you take 1 action. And you can't interrupt your movement. So you can't move, take an action, and then move. You gotta fully move and take an action, or fully take an action and then move. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I do know that I want to get strong. I know that even though I'm on a weak port, I don't want to attack it and take it over, even though it'll earn me 2 gold per round, because these guys are here, and all they do is run around reclaiming ports. All the ports are Spanish right now. So if we change them to not Spanish, the Spanish get mad at us. All right, let me think what I want. They get mad. I know, I said that weird. What do I want to do? If I take a rival adventurer here, then this, who gets to control the Spanish? I do. Oh. Then I will make the Spanish not attack me at the end of the turn. So that's maybe a possibility.
Will you know?
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to take a... So I can take an adventure action, and thank you so much, the Drew 12345. I've got that same password on my luggage. So if I take a Captain Adventure, I should actually zoom into what we're actually doing here. If I take an adventure, sorry, I got to take the adventure of the matching token that's on there, and it's the Rival Adventure. So let's switch back over to the app. Sometimes you have a lot of app involvement, especially at the beginning of the game, and sometimes you don't. So... Continue.
No. Oh, no.
Yes. So, I'm going to tell you, you got to read again. So, this is a new thing with the version 2 of the app as well. So, it was very easy to lose track of where the tokens were supposed to be, and this helps you keep track of them a lot better. Go for it.
Okay.
I'm going to move it like that. There you go.
Can you read it? Okay, cool. You arrive at a gambling den in Havana, plastered with posters advertising the Grand Gamble, Rough and Honors Tournament. This again, Axe Fist groans.
Good Axe Fist voice.
Mariah has won the gamble 3 years running. This year, I intend to end her winning streak, you say. We'll need to cheat as much as Mariah does if we want to win, Axvis says. What if we don't want to win, you suggest? What if we just make sure she loses?
What are my options?
So, you can out-cheat that cheater and claim the prize money. It costs you 2 gold. Forget winning and just make sure Mariah loses.
Hoping that the prize money is more than 2 gold, I'm going to out-cheat her and pay the 2 gold. So let's see what happens.
Okay. Using hand signals, sleight of hand, and bribes, you and Axe Fist cheat your way to the final table. However, when you take your seats to face Mariah, her seat is empty. Someone shouts, "The money! It's gone!" Brian and Barnacle, Axe Fist curses when the head porter explains the situation. Did Mariah leave anything behind? She left this, the porter says, handing you a clay replica of a bejeweled snake amulet and a note reading, "The Dream of Justice Served." We need more information. Let's go to Claw Bay to seek an audience with the legendary Merchant of Secrets and get some answers about the Dream of Justice Served, you say. Results. Lose 2 gold.
I did.
Remove Mariah's last ability.
Okay.
Draw from the tavern deck until you find an item.
Uh-huh.
Claim it immediately. Yeah. Place your Nemesis adventure token in Claw Bay.
Okay. So, I think I can remember all that while I switch over. So, Maria gets weaker, so let me just minimize this. Maria gets weaker, so this token kind of like goes to the top of a card, so she doesn't have this ability anymore. It can't activate when I do a battle-y thing with dice. Take that, Maria. And then you moved my Rival Adventure token to Claw Bay.
I did.
I lost the 2 gold, and then we are going to draw from the Tiber deck, which is going to be off-camera. You can't see it. This is a game, if you've got a small table, not a game for you. You don't want that. It's not going to work with a small table, but Cheryl's going to reach across.
One of the reasons why we just got a bigger table.
Yeah, exactly.
Was for this game.
We can play big, yeah. Big Sea Legend. Okay, so yeah. Actually, maybe you can grab the tavern deck and bring it on, and that's actually going to need a shuffle. While Cheryl's shuffling that up, I want to show you that the whole thing we're doing here is we're trying to earn notoriety points. We both start at 0 notoriety points, and you can earn notoriety points in a variety of different ways. You can beat up certain non-player characters to earn them. You can bury 10 gold. Every 10 gold you bury gets you a point. That's very much like Merchants and Marauders. You can get special relic items, and each one of those is worth a notoriety point. You can, let me see if I can get them all. If you hire crew, notice that I have crew here, and they're all worth 0 money right here. But we're not even on the screen here. Now, I have crew, and they're all worth 0 money. But if you hire crew that are worth 10 or more gold, then you get a notoriety point. So there's a few different, if you take over a port, like here, if you take over Tortuga, that'll get you 2 notoriety points. But certain places that you take over don't get you any notoriety points. So there's just a big grab bag of ways that you can earn these notoriety points. And right now we're at 0. We want to get to 10 to win the game. So Cheryl's going to start flipping cards from the tavern deck until we find one that says item. There's 2 different things on the tavern card, relics and
relic.
Items. That's a relic.
Relic.
That's a relic.
Item.
All right, so I get the orchids. So what do the orchids do for me? They say, Discard irresistible orchids to increase a lover's level or decrease a nemesis's level. Well, my nemesis is already at zero, so I'd definitely like to discard that right now to increase Axe Fist's ability. So already I'm powering up. You can take that card and throw it in the discard pile. That was my turn. Now Cheryl gets to take her turn.
Okay, yes.
What are you going to do, Cheryl?
Do I run away? No.
I'm still waiting for Knights Around the Table 2, the requests for review copies. We don't request a lot of review really copies. Don't. I promise that we don't. This is a rare case for us.
Do I run?
What are you going to do?
No, I want to do a lover adventure.
Oh, where's your lover? Oh, you're just going to stay there.
Yeah.
And you can always, like, you can take your adventure, and then move later.
Oh, let's do that.
Yeah, let's put you on camera. Yeah. And then we'll do that. Okay.
Oh,
so,
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so you're going to do a lover adventure. So back to the app. Here we go. If I ever switch to the app and I actually don't have it up on the screen, let me know, because I'm looking at a different window than you are. Here we go.
Cool.
And I'm going to do the most offensive accents I can come up with.
Please do not.
All right, here we go. You said lover, right?
Yes.
Okay. You find yourself at the edge of town in Claw Bay, waist deep in the trash heap. You grunt, heaving a burlap sack over the side. It splatters across the cobbles. You pop up and look for Maru. Why are you over there? Oh, sorry, his voice. Why are you over there? Precisely 23 feet away, Maru sticks out her tongue. I have to stay out of the splash zone. It's not that bad, you reply. Maru taps her foot, huffing while she crosses her arms. Looks pretty awful. Can't we find treasure in a cleaner way? You can feel it. These are options. You can feel it. There's treasure right under your feet. Or, clean treasure sparkles better. So do you want to keep digging or do you want to go looking elsewhere?
This time I'm going to dig.
All right. You can feel it. There's treasure right here. You start digging. Ridiculous, you reply. I can feel it. There's treasure right here. You reach down and throw a leaking sack out of the trash heap. Unfortunately, the seam breaks and it bursts in your face. Maru keels over, retching. I found a thing, you shout, holding up a small handmade globe. Fantastic, Maru replies, wiping her mouth with the back of her strong hand. You clamber down the heap, clean your find as best you can, and present it to Maru. Maru plays with the globe. Wait, there, on Tortuga, she says, showing you the globe. The symbol means cave, and the one below it means treasure. We should go investigate. So, Maru's going to remember this favor. You can unlock Maru's next ability, draw from the tavern deck just like I did until you find an item and keep it, and then your lover adventure token goes in Tortuga.
Okay.
All right, so let's see.
Oh, hilarious. I also got...
Oh, you got the irresistible orchids.
Yeah.
You can hang on to them, or you can discard them now to soup up. Also, it looks like Jules has a straddling power.
Yeah,
maybe
it's
you can move
to be
that.
There
we go. That's better.
So...
Yeah, what's going on? Do you want to discard it now and soup up Maru, or do you want to hang on to it?
I'm going to soup up Maru.
You're going to soup up Maru? I know, I did the same thing. There you go. So,
There we go.
You warped right to Maru's third ability, which I think is cheating, and while this is a pirate game, I don't think we can cheat that badly.
Where does this go again?
Tortuga? In Tortuga. But look, Cheryl, you're on the third Maru ability.
Oh. Well, I was supposed to... No, because I just finished a lover.
Oh, have you gone up twice already?
No, listen. Yes. I just moved up here.
Oh, you're right. Oh.
And so now I'm moving here.
You're right.
You're absolutely right. With the item. So I didn't cheat.
If one can discard them, they don't see irresistible of orchids. Yes. I love these orchids. Blah, in the garbage. All right. Here we go. So, once everybody's taking their turn in a two-player game that goes pretty fast, then it gets back to the person who has the start player marker, and that person now has to move the factions, the non-player factions
move.
Around. Oh, you didn't move. If you'd like to, yes, let's do that.
Right?
Yep,
so
you can still move.
So I can go 1, 2.
Okay, so you're down here.
No, you can see me. Sorry.
Great, perfect.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So, yeah, so it gets back to the person the with the start player token, and that person moves the factions around. Mm-hmm. So right now there's only one faction on the board, and that's the Spanish Armada. All of the factions, I'm going to show you something that you might also not have with your copy of the game if you have one, but you'll be getting it if you back the game on Kickstarter. There's the address. they've now done, so you used to have little booklets, and of course you have the big rule book that you can look through. They're separating that rule book for the factions out into its own book. Plus, they give you these little handy-dandy flowcharts. So if you know how a faction works reasonably well, you can just bomb down the flowchart and move it around. I'm pretty good with how these factions, well, maybe not the Atlantean usurpers, but we'll see how it goes. So there's just like it's like a logic flow of what the of what each bad guy is trying to do and where they're trying to go. So what the Spanish galleons want to do is they want to find any port that's not Spanish. So far, all the ports are Spanish because nobody's tackled a port, so forget that. The next thing they want to do is they want to go with, oh man, I might have not puzzled this out properly. They want to go and attack the nearest non-player character or player character. And I guess that's me. Shoot, I thought I could drive them towards you, but I guess I can't. So I'm the closest one. generally, when it comes down to, like, if you have a choice as the first player, you can choose where to send the factions, so you can actually sick them on your opponents, or, you know, you can figure stuff out. But here it looks like I'm the only option going, so the Spanish are going to move into my zone. And what happens then is all the different non-player characters do different things to you to attack you. So the Spanish are going to attack me, and when they do that, I just have to exhaust one of my crew members. So it's got this, you know, to show that you've used a crew member's power, you have to turn them. I think Dumas is going to get exhausted because it will be a while before his power is useful. So I'm going to exhaust him. And then you get bounced out of that C zone by the Spanish. So the nice thing about this is, again, like almost everything's positive. So even though you have to exhaust a crew member and get bounced, at least you get to pick like where you flee, which might get you closer to where you're trying to go. So I'm going to go to... Gee, all my stuff is down here. So... But if I don't get enough distance from the Spanish, they're going to come for me. Okay, I'm going to go down. Oh, yeah, I'm going to go down here to Port Royal and flee down there. So any adjacent C zone is cool. So that was me moving the factions. You have to pick one faction, move everybody in that faction, pick the other faction, move everybody, pick the third faction, move everybody. So that's all the Spanish moved. There are no other factions. And then you end the round by drawing one of these event cards, the big deck of terrible stuff. So let me go over here so you can see it a little bit better. The Atlantean usurpers. If not in play, place King Alaron in a sea region on the board's edge. Increase the level of the seekers. So this is the seeker card. So their level is going to go up. They're no longer level 6, they're level 6. Right, so they stay at level 6 for a couple of goes. Great, and then you have to do everything up to and including where the strength of the bad guy is. So here, place one seeker in a sea region as far from King Alaron as possible. Okay, I'm going to chuck this card out here. King Alaron, let's see it. We've been teasing him a little bit. So all of the big minis are like super cool. And this is King Alaron. He is a... Hold on, let me get a close up. So he's the king of the Atlanteans on a gigantic purple and blue goldfish. If you painted him, we're working on it. Just laden with Atlantean treasures that he's just like, he's saying scrambles and throwing them into the ocean. So he's going to go on an edge zone, and then the Atlantean usurper, who I'll show you here, they have big spears and they want to stab him in the face because they want their stuff. It's kind of like an inheritance situation going on, right? Like dad wants to give away all his money before he dies, and all the kids are like, the hell you do. So I'm going to put him, let me see. I've only played with these guys once. Do you think it's better to put him closer to us and the usurper like farther away so it takes longer for her to get there? And then maybe we could like collide with her and kill her on her way? I'm gonna put her there and I'm gonna put him there.
You can put him close to me if you want.
No, I don't think I will. I think I'll do that. So they're on opposite ends of the board.
You can go right next to me.
The flow charts are super nice. Yeah, they are very cool slivers. Is that slivers or silvers? It's slivers. I got slivers. It right. My game group sometimes house rules that if attacked, you can initiate a conflict battle versus exhausting and leaving the zone. Oh yeah, okay, yeah. We're on the fence about which we like more. Yeah, yeah. So the as
that's kind of Merchants and Marauders.
It's very Merchants and Marauders. Yeah. Yeah, you actually get to do a combat. You'll see how combat works probably very very shortly. So after the first player does all the faction stuff, then you pass this thing on to the next player, and in a two-player game, it kind of goes, I get a turn, she gets a turn, we pass the thing, she gets a turn, I get a turn, so you get two turns in a row in a two-player game. Mm-hmm. All right, are you ready? I'm ready. All right, yes. Do it.
Okay.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to... Since nothing's really going on, I'm going to do my Captain Adventure because I'm right here.
Okay. Yeah, it's important to kind of like power up your character before all hell breaks loose in the Caribbean, right? So let me switch over to the app. Here we are. Good.
Because it's about to break loose.
It is about to go nuts. You're in down here.
Cartagena.
Yeah.
And I'll move after that, by the way.
You and your crew set out to escort the lumberman to the docks. It's dark when you reach the allegedly haunted forest bridge. Remember, there's a ghost involved in your story. Mm-hmm. You're alarmed to see an eerie ghost on the other side. Ooh! When the translucent figure makes threatening gestures, both the lumberman and your crew begin to panic. I'd recognize that fancy, fashionable lady anywhere, Carmela cries. It's Margot! A nuisance even in death, you groan. No. It must be a trick, Carmela growls. Your options are to tell the workers to ignore the ghost and keep working. You gotta exhaust a crew member to do that. Or halt work to do a little ghost hunting.
Hunt the ghost.
Do you think it's gonna turn into like a Scooby-Doo situation? Let's see.
Or do you think I have to fight?
Let's find out. Fight. Well, it'll tell you if you need to fight. You sprint after the ghostly form of Margot, but she disappears into the darkness. You find some broken glass, a lantern, and a worn copy of Creating Spectral Illusions. Cursing, you make your way back to the tavern. Someone's pretending. I should have known that coiffed criminal was behind this all along, Carmela shouts as you tell her the story over drinks. She quakes as the blood rushes to her face. Enough! Oh, enough is enough, you say. Let's track Margot down and make her pay. I agree. I heard a rumor Margot has holed up in a sumptuous mansion. Let's go there and make her pay for her treachery, she says. The results are Caramala will remember this favor. You get to draw three crew and hire one for free, and then get an item from the tavern deck. Adventure token, Captain Adventure token goes in Havana. Wow, you get an item and three crew.
Very nice.
Okay. So let me get your camera going there. Oh, wait. Yeah, let's do that and then we'll go do the elsewhere thing. Okay. There's another prompt in the app that we have to pay attention to.
Okay, so relic.
So the relics are more valuable. They get you a point, and they're just more powerful than items are. So you got the big old cannonball. What's the big old cannonball do for you?
Discard big old cannonball to change all roses to ship's wheels to ones.
And this all has to do with dice manipulation when you're actually doing like battle combat stuff.
Okay, so I get to draw three of these guys and choose which one I want to keep.
Yes, that's a very nice reward.
Isn't it?
Remember, if you keep crew worth 10 or more gold, you get a point. And currently the scores are 0-0. Who have you got? You got a munitions expert, gambler.
So he allows me to... I can exhaust this guy to gain 3 bonus dice when I'm challenging a port region. So if I wanted to take over ports,
okay,
he would be great.
Yeah. You don't usually do that in this game, though.
I don't.
You don't.
Exhaust to change a rose or ship's wheel into a 1 on a bonus die or a 2 on a captain's die.
Very strong. Pretty awesome. And you can generally tell by the costs how good a crew member is.
Yep. And exhaust to gain 2 movements. Meh.
Eh. The movement.
So I think the gambler is a little stronger.
Yeah, the gambler's the one you want for sure.
So I'm going to add her here because I can have 4 crew. Legendary is just extra.
Yeah, legendary doesn't take up a seat on your boat.
You guys can't see those, so I'm just going to move them.
It's like a pirate conga line.
There we go.
Lovely.
Everything's good.
Lovely.
Okay, elsewhere.
Oh, right. Elsewhere in the Caribbean. Thank you. I almost forgot.
I did not.
Elsewhere in the Caribbean. This is a new thing as of the next version of the app as well. I get to do a French accent. A French galley pulls up alongside you. This is me, by the way, Captain.
No, you don't.
Sorry. As it does, a musketeer grabs a rope and swings across to your deck from a yardarm. Bring me wine, he cries. While I wait for that, I have news. He hands you a letter that reads, Captain Cesare, our spies have discovered that the Atlantean usurpers are building a citadel on Havana. My French accent is French-Canadian, apparently.
Yeah.
It is vital you sail to Havana and destroy it before they can finish. Interesting. And do I not like the Atlantean usurpers? I kind of don't.
No, because you're allied with the French. I am,
and I'm helping them. Yeah, I'm helping the French. Okay, yeah, let's go wreck their... Let's go. Will that change my captain adventure token?
I don't know if it would.
I don't know. Okay, let's do it. The mission's been added to your... Oh, it's Captain's Adventure. Look, so place your Captain Adventure token in Havana. So I am no longer kidnapping What's-Her-Face. Yep. I am now...
Destroying
a... messing up the Atlantean usurpers.
All right.
Okay, that's cool. I can deal. I can dig it. All right.
Yeah.
All right. It's a my turn.
It is. Oh, I didn't move, right?
No, I don't think you did.
I did not.
Where are you going to go? You're just running away from me. So now I could have gone onto your C-zone and taken that back. But okay.
Too late now.
What is the very best thing I can do to power up? It costs $10 to buy a ship. I have $6.
Hold on. I want to exhaust and just move
that. Wait. Do that again so we can see what you're doing.
I'm exhausting her, and yeah. I just wanted to bounce here.
Yeah, so your navigator gives you one more movement.
Yeah. I'm pirate happy. Yarr.
I think for lack of something better to do, I am going... Oh, no, because I was going to say I'm going to go drinking in Tortuga, but if I do that... then stupid Spanish will come after me again. So I can't bury anything. I don't have enough gold. I can't buy a ship. I don't have enough money. I can't really hire a crew because I don't have enough money. And his ability is to hire a crew anyway. So I probably don't want to do that. Oh my gosh. Wow, there's really nothing... There's nothing good for me to do at this position. Oh, I know what I'll do. I'll attack Cheryl. Yes. Okay. So throw down. Here's how combat looks. All I'm doing. I just wanted to give people a combat example in case they can't save the entire game. That's all I'm doing. So there are two different kinds of dice in the game. There are blue dice and there are white dice. And you always roll the four blue captain dice. And then you get, depending on your ship, you get a certain number of other dice. So if we look at my ship, it's got one cannon, so that means I get to roll one bonus die. And if we look at my crew, this is the reason I didn't exhaust this guy. I'm going to exhaust my gunner, who's going to give me one more bonus die to roll. And I think if I look, I think that's all the goodies that I get. That's everything that I get. I think. Dumas can't do anything because there's no French guys out. Yeah, okay, so let's do it. Okay, so I'm the attacker, so I roll first. And I'm trying to get the best number I can. Mm-hmm. And once I roll, I can't add any more bonus dice. I can't go like, oh, I'm going to tap this guy and add another guy. Nope, here we go. All
right, I don't know, man.
Okay, so no. My strength is currently 4, and I rolled a rose and two captain's wheels, two ship wheels. So those ship wheels I can assign to my captain card, and for every ship wheel assigned, draw a crew card, it says, and then hire one of the crew members for free. Let me just check to see what everybody else does. The quartermaster lets me change a rose... or a captain die into a 1. So I could have a strength of 5. Oh my gosh, what is this? Terrible, scary noise. I think we're being raided. With a party of 53, Lusapalooza. Oh my gosh.
Goodness.
53, that's insane.
Wow.
Welcome, everybody.
Thank you.
I don't know if you guys are in here yet.
Yeah.
But welcome, Lusapalooza. What were you guys doing? Lusapalooza, by the way, Dave, I was hoping that... Thank you very much, Dr. Aardvark, for the follow. I was hoping that we could meet at Gen Con, and then we didn't, and it was very, very sad.
It was very busy.
It was very busy. There were tons of people I wanted to meet, and I didn't get to meet practically anybody. I did get to meet... thank you very much. So what is Soli Dorjiga... That's a hard username for me to pronounce. But thank you very much for the... Dear Gloria, thank you very much for the follow. I appreciate that. Welcome. What were you guys doing over on Lusapalooza? What game were you playing? What was going on? Tell me all about it. We're playing Sea of Legends,
yes,
which is on Kickstarter. The second expansion is on Kickstarter for 2 more days, and we've fallen in love with this game, and we just wanted to play through it and show you what it's all about. And I am in the middle of a player versus player battle versus Cheryl, and so far I don't know if it's going exceedingly well. Let me just check and see. Okay, so I've rolled. I've rolled a four, and you want to get like the biggest number possible. That's your strength. So I've rolled a 4. I've got 2 captain's wheels, and I've got a rose. Over here, my buddy Axe Fist, my lover Axe Fist, does some stuff for me. So for every rose assigned, gain a strength. Big and mean, gain 2 bonus dice. Oh, remember how I said you don't gain more bonus dice after your roll? I didn't quite read his power. Can I roll 2 more bonus dice? Come on, now. I'd let you do it.
Would you?
Yes, I would. Technically, this is not allowed, but it's not like I used an ability to get more bonus dice. I just should have rolled them from the top. So that's what I missed. But you're in luck. I rolled a dagger, but it doesn't matter because my rival doesn't do anything to me. Ooh, getting the commercial now. Yeah, sorry, Dave. It's I don't know. I personally believe in this game, so I'm doing all I can to raise awareness about it. Great. So she's not going to do anything bad to me, which is great, but it just means the dagger goes to waste. I don't know whether to draw crew with these ship's wheels or to beef him up so that I can kick Cheryl's butt a little bit harder.
Or just rest your pirate case.
Okay, here's what I'm going to do. For every rose assigned, gain 1 strength, so I'm going to assign a rose. I'm going to tap my quartermaster and turn one of my ship's wheels into... Mm-hmm. Into a 1. So back to here. I'll turn this ship wheel into a 1. And then I will use this final 1 to assign to Cesare. And that lets me draw a crew card and then hire 1 for free. So hopefully draw me somebody good, Cheryl, from the crew deck. Let's go. Oh, we didn't shuffle the crew deck either, I don't think. But you've already drawn from it, so it's cool. All right, what have we got? What have we got? I get the Charming Rogue, not my favorite crew member, but exhaust 1 bonus die for each nemesis ability you have unlocked. I don't really like him that much, and he's cheap, so that means he's generally not good. But the more salient point... give a little hug for me, please. Tell Bo I need... You guys are talking amongst yourselves. Go ahead, keep going. So yeah. My strength is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Beat 6, sucka. So what are you rolling? Everybody remember 6 is the number to beat, because I am going to forget. What are you rolling over there? Are you tapping anybody to get more bonus dice?
I have questions.
Yes.
Yes.
What are your questions?
So, what does... questions about her power. It says, gain 1 bonus die against followers and gain 3 bonus die against leaders.
That's NPCs.
What does that mean?
So, if you're... Okay. The small guys are the followers and the big minis are the leaders.
Got it.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
So you can't quite use that yet, because
nope. You're
not funny. Go, Cheryl, says DJ Maki. You mutinous! You mutinous Yarr. Crew! What is happening? Already, they turned against me.
So I get
clearly, I'm the superior pirate.
1 for my ship.
Yes.
I'm exhausting my gunner to get me 1 more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then... I'm going to exhaust Karamala.
New rule, Cheryl gets 3 bonus dice because she's awesome. Hold on now. I'm gonna check the book on that one. I don't think they've written it there. All right, what does Karamala do for you?
I'm not in an adjacent region of the king.
No.
Damn.
Haha! I knew I placed him somewhere good.
Yeah, I was trying to trick you.
Were you now?
It's piracy.
It is piracy. Rolled 6 allegedly. No, take a screenshot, somebody, please. I have a strength of 6.
I'm pretty sure it was a 5.
I'm sticking to my guns on it. Okay. I remember a 3. Hold on. Omelette, can you kick yourself out of chat, please? You'd be dying to banhammer somebody. I give you permission to banhammer yourself.
Okay. All right,
what'd you get?
2, 4.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. This is bad for me.
Yeah. Well, you got 5 so far.
This is bad.
Let's get it on camera. Let's get your defeat on camera. Ooh, 3 daggers!
Yep.
3 daggers!
So I roll 1 or more, I lose a strength.
Oh, beautiful.
Beautiful you, whatever.
Yeah, beautiful me, that's right. Uh-oh, that's bad news. What else you got going on? I don't think you're coming back from that, Cher.
Stop it.
Okay, yeah. What now? She's just like trying desperately. There's got to be some loophole. She's putting her face off camera so you can't see her agonized looks. Okay. Well, what's it going to be? I think it's defeat. What are you going to do with this rose, though? Can you do anything with that?
Turn it into a strength, but I've lost the strength because of this bullcrap roll.
So it looks to me like...
So I end up with a 5.
Yes, which is higher or lower than a 6. I think, I mean, I'm no great math mind, but...
Yeah,
so I win that bout.
Yeah.
This is why Rado had me do the game, because he's not into player killing, but you know what? I'm okay with it, especially when I win. So, to the victor, the spoils, and the spoils are...
Okay.
The spoils are as follows. If Cheryl had a relic, I could take one of her relics. She doesn't. Eventually, we're going to be beating up these 19 usurpers to take tokens from them that we can bring to the king for treasure. If Cheryl had a token, I could take it from her. She doesn't. So the only other thing I can take from her as spoils is money. So I get 5 gold from Cheryl for beating her up. That's right. Okay.
How many exhausted crew do you have right now?
I have 2 exhausted crew.
Okay.
Why? 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 What does it matter?
Oh, no reason.
So much poking the bear going on here.
No reason at all.
Okay.
No, wow. Of course. There's never a reason for that.
Okay, so you get to move we're back to you, so you get to move the NPCs. So
Cool.
Which faction do you want to move? Do you want to move the Spanish or the Atlanteans?
I'm gonna move the Atlanteans.
Okay, so when you move
How
the Atlanteans,
many does he go?
The king always moves first. So you have to move him before you move any of the usurpers. And he has, let me just check the card up here. His movement point is listed as 1, so he can go 1.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
And the...
Yes?
The follower, like the...
Yes.
Atlanteans.
Usurpers, yes.
Yes, usurpers, thank you. How many movement points do they have?
They have, back to their card, I'll point it out to you up here, they also have 1 movement point.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. And they want to go towards him, and he wants to go away from them. So
right.
I believe the only place that you can move him, and I might be wrong, Guildhall can correct me on this, is down in the bottom left corner, because that's the only away move that they can make.
Or I move him closer to me. Yeah.
Because I think moving up to... Oh, I guess you could go up to Skull Point as well.
Nah, he'll go to Claw.
Go down here? Okay, let's put him so he's on camera. Cause
they're going to go down to... It's embarrassing.
I know.
Cool. There, and then the Spanish are going to go towards us.
Yes, the Spanish are going to go shoot. I didn't even see that coming. No. Unfortunately, the Spanish can reach us quite easily in 1 move. So they will.
Oh.
So the Spanish go to
right.
us. No, NPCs can move 2 different ways. They can move recklessly or they can move cautiously. When an NPC moves cautiously, they'll avoid stronger NPCs. When they move recklessly, they will just bulldoze their way through and who cares who they meet and get beat up by along the way. So the Spanish move cautiously, but all captains, player captains, are considered weaker than them. You don't have to roll or anything. They just move into our C-zone. And then there's 2 ways they can attack. They either attack like individually or like everybody on the C-zone. So Spanish attack, they do a region attack. They attack absolutely everybody. So that means that both of us have to exhaust a crew member and both of us get bounced. So you got to exhaust a crew member. Who are you exhausting? Uh-huh. All right, thank you so much for your moderation so far, Almut. We'll see you when you jump back. And I get to exhaust a crew member. I'm going to exhaust my charming rogue because he's pretty useless to me right now. He's not a great crew member. Now we each get to choose where we're going to flee to. Where are you going to flee to?
And I have to choose first?
Oh, that's a great question. Who chooses first?
I assume...
Oh, that's a really good question. That's a great question. I don't know. Who chooses
first?
Well,
I assume if I'm moving the things, that would be me, right?
I don't know. I don't want to have to go to the rulebook. Maybe if Guildhall's listening, one of the Guildhall crew members can tell us who moves first. Whatever happens, Cesare's going to go up there. Where's Tun going?
So why did you choose first?
Ferris announces, I've stolen Cheryl's booty.
Yes.
Darn right.
So where... So you've just decided that you're going to choose
I've
first.
Just decided that I'm choosing first.
Cool.
I don't want to wait for them to give us a ruling. Does it matter?
How much gold do I get from you if I fight you?
5.
Only 5?
Yeah.
If I would just steal back?
Yeah. It's 5, right? It's not half. Wait, maybe I do have to open the rule book. Oh, no. I was trying to avoid this.
I think it's half.
Okay, well, let's look.
Is it?
Well, that would make more sense, but let's take a quick peek. We don't really
round it down or round it up. We don't do PvP very
often.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Player versus player outcomes. The win. Oh, it's half. You're right. Half rounded down. Oh, which means I get even more gold, doesn't it?
No,
it means I get 4, not 5.
Exactly.
Okay, here's your.
Give me my 1 gold.
Okay, I need 4.
You make me make change.
Yes, you got to make change.
1.
Thank you. And then our other question is, who moves first? I see, because you're trying to chase me and fight me.
I'm not going to say you're welcome, because we're pirates.
I'm going to spend your money on something nice.
That wasn't willing.
Okay.
Yes?
Now what?
I will move.
Interesting. 2 Tortuga. Now the first player marker goes to me, and it's my turn. And what I'm going to do is spend Cheryl's money. Ha ha ha.
Wait, I could also bounce here, right?
Yes, if you want to, but yeah, you're going to have to decide before I do my big power play.
I'm doing this!
Okay. I am going to go to Smuggler's Cove.
And spend my money.
And spend your money. So I got 10 gold to blow. Whoops, that's not it at all. I got 10 gold to blow on a new ship. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10.
How do you have that much money already?
I took it from you.
You only took 4 from me.
I started with 8. I lost 2 in that adventure, down to 6. I took 4 from you. That's 10. And I'm going to spend the 10.
It's 15 for a ship.
Is it 15 for a ship? No.
Yes.
Oh, no.
Class 2 ships are 15.
Oh, no. I've made a terrible mistake. Okay.
See? 15.
Yeah. Yeah, they believe you. Shoot. Okay. Darn. Well.
It's like you haven't even played this game, Ryan.
I could... I could do something really nefarious.
Ryan does math.
Yeah, he totally does. Which I'm not going to play that because then just... The way I have things set up, it's going to play incessantly for the rest of the stream. Okay. I could bury it. I could bury it.
Why would you... No, you need a better ship, because then you won't be able to fight all of the crap that's on the board.
Maybe I can just let you fight.
Oh, that's not going to work.
No, eh?
No.
I could let you fight. This is the thing. I can't get down here and drink. I desperately need a beer, or an ale, or a grog.
How strong are those guys?
They're 6 right now.
Oh.
I'm going to... Okay, yeah, I'm going to go and I'm going to bury it. So when you go to a...
Wild choice! Yes,
when you go to a port, this is probably a really bad idea.
I would not.
Oh, maybe that's a really bad idea. No, you know what?
I shouldn't counsel you?
No, you shouldn't counsel me.
You should
bury
your gold.
I'm going to hang on to my gold. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Smuggler's Cove and I'm going to take over the port.
Oh.
Did we miss... drawing a faction card on your turn? No, we didn't. We drew the Atlanteans on your turn. So that's going to be... I'm only rolling 5 dice, though.
Right, but do you draw...
At the end of your
faction turn. We didn't...
Yeah. Didn't we? So for me, the Spanish got drawn. Did we miss it?
We missed it, because I moved.
No.
We chose where we were going to move.
Yeah. I think you're right.
And then we didn't pull a card. We need an event card.
Okay, get an event card going. Yeah. What has changed? What did you do on your turn? Nothing. Right.
Nothing.
Right. So, back I go. Right.
This might change everything.
Okay, what
else? It is the French Empire.
Oh, good.
You increase the level of the Musketeers.
Musketeers are now 5.
Okay. With 5, place 1 Musketeer in a sea region.
Place 1 Musketeer, and it's your choice where the Musketeer goes.
My choice. Okay. A sea region, huh?
15 to 35 for class 3. 15 counts towards the 35. Yeah, that's right, Slivers. You can buy the first boat for 15, like the class 2 boat. And then if you want to buy... If you just jump directly to the class 3 boat, you pay the full 35. But if you're going from a class 2 to a class 3, you only pay 20 bucks.
Yeah.
And each boat is worth points to you. So the first ship you get... if you get a class 2, it's worth a point. If you get a class 3, it's worth 2 points.
Yes.
But if you trade in your class 2 boat, this is, I think, a rule that's easy to get wrong. You hang on to the point that you had for this... For that class 2 boat.
Oh, you do?
Even though you're getting rid of the boat.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Cool.
I'm going to put these dice away. This might not be the best idea. Now what?
What do you get for killing these guys again?
Wait, what does he do? You put him on a C zone, right?
Yeah, I put him here.
And that's all he does. What do you get for killing these guys?
He's
well,
like
every single...
Here.
NPC card has a reward listed, and at the bottom of his, it says 7 gold, or you capture the French port in this region.
That he's on.
That he's... Yeah.
7 gold.
That's 7 gold.
That's cool.
And he's a strength 5, so he's pretty easy to...
He's floating gold for me.
He's floating gold. Strength 5, but all of my crew is exhausted. Yeah, I can't same. Attack
Why
him.
Why would that be, well, Ryan?
And do you remember how to unexhaust your crew?
Yeah, you take a port action.
Right, any port action will unexhaust all of your crew. So I don't have the money to buy a ship. I don't have the strength to take over a port. It's going to be a wasted turn if I try to do that. I could bury the gold. I don't want to bury the gold down here because I'd be in the path of the Atlantean. It seems like a terrible idea. No, that'd be a terrible idea.
How strong are the Atlanteans?
How strong are the Atlanteans? They are 6.
Okay.
How strong are the Spanish? Wait a second. That's the plague. No, I shouldn't kill the Spanish.
Do not.
I want to take out the Spanish. I want to take out the Spanish.
Please don't.
I really want to take out the Spanish.
Yeah, but if you...
Mm. I'm going to take out the Spanish because the French are my friends. I'm going to take out the Spanish. Okay, I'm moving here. I'm moving here to take out the Spanish.
You're going to be like...
Yes.
Job.
All right. I know. This is going to be disastrous for me.
It's
the
bad
Spanish
news.
Are 5. I'm only rolling 5 dice, but let's see how it goes. 5 dice because you always get the 4 captain dice. I get 1 for my ship, and all my crew are exhausted, so none of those bums are going to do anything for me. Okay, I got 1 dagger, it doesn't matter. 1, 2, 3, 4, and a rose. And if I take the rose, Axfest says if I assign the rose... Oh, I get 2 more bonus dice, I always forget. Wait, I get to roll 2 more, hold on.
You can't currently ally...
Can't currently ally with any factions for a co-win. Yeah, because there's an issue in the app right now. So 2, 3, 4, 5, I do it. I'm successful. Hooray. But I can assign these roses to Axe Fist. Oh, just to gain strength. Wow, Axe Fist is like punchy. I like him. So great. I defeat the Spanish and I get 7 gold.
That is the worst.
Kerplunk, splash.
With like...
Is it 7 or 5? It's 7.
How did you do that?
Hold on. Yeah, 7 gold. Amazing.
They were there in Thieves Landing and you moved there?
Yes. I moved there and I murdered them. So I was up here and I moved down here and I got rid of them. I got my revenge. Take
Even
that Spanish.
Even with your exhausted crew?
Even with my exhausted crew. Because Axe Fist, in addition to being a good kisser, he also gives me additional weaponry to fight things. So, you're up. You're going after the French, huh?
I might do it. If you could do it, then maybe I can do it.
Yes, I am your inspiration.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, I got my 4. I'm losing my pirate.
Get your 4 captain dice?
Whatever.
What else do you have to declare?
I get 1 for my ship.
Yes.
And that's about it.
That's all you get? You didn't exhaust anybody?
Crew is exhausted.
What about your big old cannonball? What does that do again?
I can discard it to change all roses and ship's wheels to 1s.
Okay, well, let's see what the roll is.
So.
All right, let's do it. Incoming French wind, says Slivers. 2 right.
5,
yeah, truer words were never
6.
Spoken.
It's a dagger, which cancels this one out, but it's a 5, so does that mean I do it?
4, 5, 6. Oh, the dagger cancels that. It's a 5, and they're at level...
5.
Let's check their level again. Let's check their level. They're at level... 5. Yes, you kill the Frenchie.
Whee!
Yoink. And you get as a prize 7 monies.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, very good, very good.
I sure do.
Okay, and 1 more threat is removed from the Caribbean.
Sorry.
However, now threats increase. So he's about as backed into the corner as he can possibly get. And she, the Atlantean usurper, is going to move towards him. So she's going to... He has to move first. He wants to move away from her. So he's backed into a corner. He's not going anywhere. And she's just going to go over here. And that's the end of the faction turn. We're going to draw an event card. The Atlantean usurpers. If not in play, place King Alaron in sea region. He is in play. Increase the level of the Atlantean seekers. So the seeker goes down. So she's now a level 7. Very scary. Place one, and then we do both of these things. We do 6. We do 6 and 7. I should probably put it on the side camera so you can see it a little bit better.
Yes.
So because she's level 6 and level 7, you do level 6 and level 7.
No!
Place one seeker in a sea region as far from King Alaran as possible, and place one seeker in a sea region as far from King Alaran as possible. Oh my gosh, can you believe it?
So no.
Two seekers as far from him as possible. He's in this corner. This is not a sea region. They don't like to be in the same region as each other. So there's 3 murderous Atlanteans going after King Alaran down here in the corner. Mm-hmm. And we're going to have to do something about that real soon. But for now, it's your turn. Cheryl's primping. She's doing not pirate primping.
My pirate cap won't stay on. Whatever.
All right.
Okay. I am...
What are you? Look, all your crew's lying down. Except for the gambler.
I know, I'm kind of stuck here, so I think that I'm going to go to Havana and do tavern action, right?
Okay, so to do a tavern action, there's a whole tavern deck of cards that's kind of off camera that you can't see. But Cheryl's going to draw 3 of them. We've already seen them being drawn as bonus actions, and we can keep the items on them, but this is like the canonical tavern action. So,
yes.
So draw, let me get out of the right camera. Draw 3 tavern cards from the top of the tavern deck.
Thank you.
One. 2. Oh, wait, 3. No, just 1. You're doing a tavern action. I just get
1?
I'm confusing it with crew. So flip it to its light side up. So they're rotatable. So the first thing is going to be some sort of game. So what's the game?
Pistol fishing contest.
What happens in the pistol fishing contest?
Gain 3 gold or gain 10 gold and increase your nemesis level.
Tough decisions.
I
10 gold. What would you do?
I'm gonna take the 10 gold.
She's taking the 10 gold, ladies and gentlemen. The rival goes up, 10 gold. 10 right. gold it is.
Okay.
Alright. And then the other thing is that is there a rumor or is there an item?
There is a rumor.
Oh, what does the rumor say?
Are you supposed to know?
I think it's public. I could be wrong, but I think
everyone knows Clabbe is famous for handy hooks. What are you waiting for?
So there's something going on in Clabbe. So she's gonna try to make it down to Clabbe, and if she enters that C zone and there's no baddies there, then she gets to turn that rumor around and gain the relic that's on the other side and get a point. Very cool. Here we go. And how are the scores doing? Oh, look, we're both still at 0. Right, here we go. But things are about to heat up now.
They're about to.
That was your turn. Now it's my turn.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go Shazam-a-blam, thread the needle between the 2 Atlantean usurpers and the 2 seekers. And I have this horrible amount of gold. I'm going to take a port action. And in taking a port action, everybody wakes up because grog is life-sustaining. Get up there. And it's a ship port, so I'm going to spend 5, 10, 15. Do I have that number right now? 1, 2, 3,
yeah,
4,
it's 15.
5. It's 15 bucks. I got the 15 bucks, and I'm going to spend those 15 bucks on a ship. So pass me the deck, just because I want to show the nice people what it looks like.
Yes, of course.
So when you buy a ship, so there's level 2 ships and there's level 3 ships. All the level 2 ships, the stats are the same. The only thing that's different is the name on the ship. The level 3 ships that cost 35 bucks or 20 if you're upgrading a level 2 ship. These are the ones where the stats are a little bit different. But all the level 2 ships are amazing because they get you 3 cannons. So that means you get 3 extra dice to roll. So I'm going to have some serious firepower after I take the Fleetwood. Boom. And you replace your old ship. And this goes back in the ship deck. Where did I put them all? There you go. Trying to reach so I don't wreck anything. Okay.
All right.
Oberon says, really? I know I've gotten a single item for neutral, which is handy. I didn't know about the bug for ally, though. Yeah, I think you can't get both items at the moment because of a bug in the app. There are 2 items. Generally, for each faction, there are 2 items that, through doing adventures, you can collect them. And the first item makes you neutral to a certain faction. And then if you get the second item, you're friends with that faction. Now, suddenly, you can pass through their sea zones. You can do stuff with their ports. Different things happen. They won't attack you. So it changes the dynamic of you versus the NPCs quite a bit. So now I got a smoking kick butt ship and I'm ready to start. I'm just gonna lay waste to the Caribbean and start killing some of these seekers. So I'm very excited about that. But it is your turn as the first player to do something with the NPCs. So, which faction do you want to move first? The only faction on the board is the Atlantean Usurpers. The fish has to go first, and the fish can't go anywhere because it's already backed into a corner. So I believe stays? I have that correct. Yeah, let me just double check the flow chart. We'll move away from the nearest seeker. Yeah, like he's as away as you can possibly get. Thank you, Bayon Joe, for your follow on YouTube. Appreciate that. So yeah, so each one is going to move closer. So there's one. There's two. And she's going to go... So Cheryl kind of has a choice between this one and this one, so she's going to put her right there. Okay.
I forgot to refresh my crew when I took a tavern action. That was the whole reason I took a tavern
Correcto. Action. Yeah, you're good. All right,
Heads up.
Oh, and I should mention that as far as scores go, Ryan now has 1 point because he got a boat. Hooray. And the points are marked by these little tokens here that unfortunately look very much like the money. So let me just compare the silver ones with the, they're very similar. They both have a skull and crossbones on them. I would have preferred a kind of a different design on both of those tokens. But what you do is you take one and you put it on your captain card to indicate that you got a point, and you can lose those points throughout the game as well. So if, if you get a relic, that gets you a point, and then if you get the relic stolen, then you lose that point for that relic, and on it goes. Great, so now you got to draw an event card.
Oh, right. French Empire, increase the level of the Musketeers.
Okay.
What level are they now?
They're currently level 6.
Okay, so we place one musketeer in a sea region, mm-hmm. and then place a musketeer in a sea region, and another one. And next round, the reward for Spanish galleons is increased by 5 gold, but there are no
Spanish galleons.
So
you get to place 2 guys in sea regions.
Great.
And might I say, yeah, like you could place them strategically so that they're going to... Well, yeah. He's got to be sea region. Yeah, so that's pretty good, because I can already see, like, a collision course might happen here. I think she's going to want to go here, but he's also, if the French move first, he's going to want to attack this port.
Maybe you want to start...
I'll talk through it when we get to it.
Yeah?
But I'm going to definitely bring up the rear and start smoking some Atlanteans, because I am rolling a horrid amount of dice right now. So I'm going to scoop for my move down here and roll just an obscene amount of dice. So there's my 4 captain dice. There are my 3 dice for my ship. Because Axe Fist, my lover, is at level 2, I gain 2 more bonus dice. Thank goodness I remembered that. And I could even, there's 2 French guys, so Dumas exhaust to gain 1 bonus die for every 2 musketeers in play. I think I will. So I'm going to exhaust him and get another bonus die, and I don't know. Should I do my gunner? Is that overkill? Is that overkill? That might be overkill. Let's see. I got to defeat.
Fine.
I think I'm fine. The Atlanteans are at 7.
Oh, man.
I don't know. You know what? I'm just gonna not my quartermaster. I'm gonna tap my gunner just so I can get 1 more die out of this. Okay. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 dice. Here we go.
That's too much.
That's probably overkill.
Yeah, you're.
But I really, really, really want to succeed.
Daggers. No.
See, look at this. Okay, so let's tally it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You're good.
I think I'm good, but there's extra goodies that
and
I get.
Now you have goodies.
And I have total goodies.
You have crew goodies.
These I can change into ones, but I don't need to, so I've totally defeated the bad guy. But check this out. I can take these 3 captain dice, and I can assign them to my captain, and for every one assigned, I get to draw a crew card. So draw me 3, if you could, 3 crew cards. And with this, like, when you get to draw and keep, if you're using a power like that, you can't, like, draw, keep. You have to do your entire draw and then just keep 1 from that. So here are my options. I've got, I love the physician. He refreshes another crew. The shipwright exhausts to gain 1 movement, gain 2 bonus dice if you move before you declare a challenge. Pretty good. The bard rocks. Exhaust to gain 1 bonus die for each lover ability you have unlocked.
Oh, I've never had him.
Love them. That's love them.
Pretty rad.
But how many crew can I hold? I can only hold 4 crews. Dumas doesn't count. I don't like the navigator.
You need to get the 35 ship that can give you more crew.
Yeah. There's I wish I could keep all of you. You're all so special. But I'm gonna. The ship rate is worth more money, but only by a bit. I love the bard. He's one of my favorite. So I'm gonna get him and get rid of this crew. And if you could discard these, that'd be great. Thank you so much. All right. Here
we go. You're dead to me.
Oh my gosh. So the other thing that happens is I knock this Atlantean usurper off the map. I get a point for beating her. I don't think you knew that.
What? Do you get points for those guys?
I get a point for getting her, so there's a...
You didn't tell me. I can't see their cards, which is not very helpful.
I'm telling you now. And then I also get a trophy token. So here's a little trophy token, and if you wanted to, you could come steal it from me, but that's just going to travel around here with me. And if I go and I cash that in with the king, then he's going to give me a really good piece of loot, a relic that's worth a point and does cool stuff for me.
But you're allied with the French.
So? Okay. So I can still go shopping with the nutso king and giving away all the kids' inheritances. It's your turn.
It is. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a quick and boring turn.
You're going up to Skull Point. Are you going to buy a boat?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I am. Because I need to kick some pirate ass. Oh.
Oh. No, no. You need to what?
Kick some pirate buttocks.
Oh my gosh.
There we go.
Okay.
You have to bleed me.
6 and... Oh no. Uh-oh. Okay. All right, so it's back to my turn. I get to move the faction now. I gotta be crafty about this because the Atlantean usurpers are at a level 7, and the French are at a level 6. So I can get the Atlantean usurpers to kill. No, I can't. I can't get them to kill the French.
We have to save the king.
Yeah. We do. Well, look, okay, so let's say I move the Atlanteans first. The king moves first, and he's stuck in the corner, so I believe...
Is he stuck, or can he move here, because that's further away?
He can move here, yes, because he's further away, which I think he'll do.
Well, but not really.
If I keep him here... No, because that moves him closer to here. I think I have the option of either moving him up here or staying here, because it's 6 of 1, half a dozen of the other, right?
Yeah.
So I've got that option, but I think I would want to keep him here because... I'll tell you why. Because now he's 1-2 away or 1-2 away. So she can either go here or here when she moves. And if I make her go here, she'll beat up this French guy, right? And then she will go, he's 1-2-3 away, 1-2-3 away, 1-2-3-4 away. So she can't go up here and beat up that guy. But at the very least, I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move the Atlanteans first. So she's going to knock him off the board, and up here, she can't go up here because it's not close enough, so she's going to go down here. Now, the French are going to move, and the French want the weakest, closest port, so I can make him beat up Nassau or Thieves Landing. And I think I want to make him beat up Thieves Landing. Now, this is where things get really interesting. Here we go. So he's going to go to Thieves Landing, and he's a level 6, and so that equals or matches Thieves Landing's port amount. It's a 6 right here. So what happens is we go to the card, and we take the top French flag off the Tarasque card and put it on Thieves Landing. Okay, so that's the first thing that happens. Are you ready? Because the second thing that happens is... The Tarasque enters the Caribbean. The Tarasque is a terrifying...
This is the noise he makes every time.
Every single time. That's the noise. That's the noise that the Tarasque makes.
Okay.
If they could have put a chip inside the thing, it would go... It'd be like a big, like, Christopher Nolan, bassy, vibrating foghorn. Anyway, so the Tarasque lands in Thieves Landing. After you put the first French flag on there, the Tarasque comes in and joins the fray.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a mobile port. Let's take a look at the card a little bit. It's a mobile port with a strength of, my bad, with a strength of 8 right now. So you can go and take it over just like you take over any port, but it's pretty strong. But if you do, you get 1 point for doing it. You can sail to the Tarrasque and take any of these port actions if you pay 2 gold. So you can take multiple port actions on your turn if you're at the Tarrasque. The other interesting thing about the Tarrasque is that when you're on a sea zone with the Tarrasque, it blocks everything that's in the sea zone. So this Thieves Landing port isn't even accessible anymore because it's just that it takes over everything. So much so that this guy, this French guy, isn't even on Thieves Landing anymore. This guy is on the Tarrasque. And when you back Sea of Legends, Vengeance of the Empires, on Kickstarter, been running for 2 more days on Kickstarter, when you get Vengeance of the Empires, they've actually changed this card to be Tarrasque-shaped. So it's a big turtle lion-shaped sort of card to sort of reinforce the idea that it's this big, floating, moving island. So that's what's going on with the Tarrasque. It's big and scary, but peaceful. Like, it's not going to attack us unless the French run around and put all these flags in the ports. Then the Tarrasque, for whatever reason, gets super annoyed and gets closer to winning the game. So,
yep.
There we go. Tarrasque is on the board and is now available. Great. Was that the... That was just me moving them. That wasn't even the event card. Now the event card happens. Okay, ready? That was a lot. The Atlantean Usurpers. So King Alaron, if not... Yeah, okay. So he's already in play. We increased the level of the Seekers. So they're now level 8, Cheryl.
No.
Very, very powerful.
Okay, all right.
And so... Place a Seeker in a sea region, place a Seeker in a sea region, and the next round, Seekers gain 1 movement. Each player must increase a Nemesis's level. Oh, that's bad.
Oh, so that hurts
me. Nemesis goes up. And we're going to put, like, a little token on... I'll put, like, another, like, knifey token on the Seekers just to remember that this round they've got an extra level. So we'll do that. And then do we have 2 more Seekers to put on the board? We do. So they go as far away from him as possible, right? Mm-hmm. So one will go up here in a sea region, and one will go down here in a sea region, and you're the first player. Go for it. Peaceful for now, says Guildhall Studios. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. We want to keep him peaceful.
So I don't think I can take out.
Why, are you weak? You have a ship.
Okay.
Okay. You can't reach them. That's your problem. You could reach her, no problem.
Yeah.
Right? And that might be a good play. At least to take one out.
Would you reach one of... Reach her?
I can reach this one down... this one down here. Right? So if I go from here to here, I can get her. I think... One, two... Can you...
Because if I go
You have your navigator.
If I go get her...
Yeah.
And she's adjacent, right? It says if you're adjacent or sharing a region, I can get 2 additional bonus dice.
Do you lose Karamala because you're killing her people? Or is Karamala siding with the king, does it say?
I think she sides with the king.
Interesting. Hmm.
Because I get bonus dice if I'm next to him, so that would mean that she wants to protect him.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, I'm going
to... It's open to interpretation.
I'm going to turn my navigator, so I get 1 additional movement point, right? So one, two, three.
So you're in the same zone.
Yep.
Ton's going to mess you up. Remember, Ton's got extra, like, strength bonuses, too.
Yep. So.
So.
Okay, so I get 3 dice for my...
Okay, we're doing it.
3 bonus dice for that.
Well, hold up. Where's the dice? I'm hogging them all. So, 4 captain dice, plus 3 for your ship. Yep. What else?
1 for my gunner.
1 for your gunner.
Tap your gunner. I'm going to exhaust to gain 1 for Karamala.
Okay.
And then I get an additional 2 because I'm next to...
Next to a seeker?
No, the king.
Oh, next to the king. Oh, yeah. She's loyal to the king for sure.
So that's it.
That's pretty good, though.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. I'm going to move these guys out of the way because there's going to be some dice chucking. Yeah. Get over here, friends.
Get them all. Okay.
Looking decent.
Mm-hmm.
Put them all down in the corner and we can zoom in. There you go.
I like to group them.
Okay, let's keep them in the shot. All right. So natively you got 5.
Yep.
3 daggers, that's bad. And...
That is really bad for me.
But the captain wheel gets you 1 more, right? Look, critical hit. You can assign it to Ton to get 1 more.
I think I have to deal with the Nemesis. If I roll one, or, and they're cumulative?
You don't have to deal with the daggers until the very end. But it might, I mean, it might have bearing now. But you can just, basically, you manipulate the dice to get the best number possible, and then deal with the...
But I don't have anything to manipulate them.
Right. So they're just going to grind down your power, right?
So I want to figure that out now.
Oh, I don't know if you can.
Why?
I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Okay, right. Go for it. Go.
Do listen, what you need to do. Listen. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They're cumulative, right?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, so all three of those things happen. They don't happen three times each, just all three happen.
If I roll one or more, I lose one strength.
Yeah, so you're going to lose one strength.
Yeah. So.
Let's put that aside. Yeah.
To deal with. That was a one, so that just cancels that out.
Yep.
If I roll two or more, I lose 3 gold for every ship's wheel rolled.
Okay.
But. Yes. We're going to put a pin in that ship's wheel.
Okay, yeah.
Right?
You might change it, right?
I think I'll change it.
Yeah.
And then if I roll 3 or more, which I did,
yeah,
I discard an item or a relic. What if I use the item first?
You can do that, because the daggers resolve at the very end of combat. Cool. So you're allowed to get rid of the cannonball. Again, Guildhall, if you're still watching, correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, I think she can get rid of the big old cannonball before the rival makes her waste it. So can you use the big old cannonball to manipulate, the ship's wheel, or...?
I'm going to use it to manipulate this to a one.
There we go.
And then these two ones.
What does it do? It lets you change all roses and... Okay, yeah.
And so then that way, I didn't roll one of those.
Yeah, you don't have...
And I don't have an item to discard.
Okay, pretty good.
Nice try.
You still lose this power, though, right? Like that... That still takes that away.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, he's 7. You're so close. You're one away. You can't do it.
Because I didn't.
Oh, so close.
My blues were all ones, right? I should have checked that before.
Yeah, I think so. Oh, does your quartermaster do anything for you?
My gambler would have turned it to a 2 if it was a blue and a captain star, but I don't think it was.
Your gambler would have turned what to a 2? A rose or a ship's wheel. Was anybody paying attention to what the blue dice were?
Oh, never mind.
Yes, what do you got?
Before I used that item, sorry, I had 2 roses.
Yes, you did.
And they were, let's pretend, yes, yeah. I didn't change them. I assigned 2 roses to gain 3 strength.
Yeah, that's better.
Yeah. Because I just needed to get rid of the ship's wheel so that I didn't
lose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You got it.
I got it.
Yeah. You just didn't want to lose the gold.
I didn't want to lose the gold. I didn't want to, like, lose
You use the item to change just one die. And then the other ones get you the strength. Yeah. I think
so
you did it.
So
I'm
going to lose the item anyway.
I think you did it.
Yeah.
All right. So she gets whirled off the board. You get...
Yay!
What do you get?
Take that.
No, you get a point. So let's update your score. I noticed you had a point on your captain. Where's that from? Your ship, right? So let's get you a point for that and a point for defeating that seeker.
Neck and neck.
All right. So 2 points each. There you go. Throw that on your captain card.
Okay.
Very good. And you get a fancy... Oh, you get one of these. Oh, but it goes on the board. Sorry. It goes on the board where your captain is. So you get a little token that you can cash in for... Fat Atlantean loot. Let's put it here because it's hard to see when you're. Yeah, and you're right next to him too.
I'm protecting the king.
There's no way I'm going to get to him. He's too far away. But he doesn't want to go anywhere near her. Basically, I want to take her out, right? Anyway, that was your turn. It's my turn, right?
Yeah. I mean, if you want to take out the ones that are down there.
Oh, yeah. I was going to take out these guys.
Because there's no shortage of them.
There is no shortage of them. Let me just see what's going on with the crew. Now, I foolishly exhausted so many crew members defeating that last one, but I think I'm still good for it. I'm feeling pretty powerful. And I'm going to take the one on that is closest to him. So I'm going to take my little token and move down here. I'm going to fight her. So throw me the 4 captain dice. I like this loadout. 4 captain dice plus 3 for my ship.
No.
Plus 2 for my lover Axe Fist, because he rules. Plus, I'm going to knock down my bard, exhaust him to gain 1 bonus die for each lover ability you've unlocked. So that's 2 more dice. Oh, yeah. And then do I have anything else to declare? That'll be it for the moment. Okay, time to roll. So we're going to take
down... a lot of dice.
Yeah, but they're eight. They're eight strength. All right. One, two, three, four, five. Whoa, oh, shoot. What was that?
I don't know.
Is that a rose? Let's say that was a rose. I think that was a rose.
Couldn't see it from your
hand. One, two, three, four, five. Anyone want to back that up and tell me what it was? I believe it was a rose. Six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I've got one dagger. That's no good. What does my rival do to me? Slap on the wrist. If you roll one or more, you lose a strength. Don't like it.
No.
Don't like it. What does my quartermaster do? Exchange a rose or a wheel. Turn it into a one. So this, like yours,
cancels
reduces my strength, and I'm at six. Oh, and then for every rose assigned to Axe Fist, gain a strength.
Good night, DJ McVee.
Good night, DJ McVee. It's late in UK land. Thanks for joining us briefly.
Yes, thank
the
you.
Reason why you're seeing a giant shadow cast over is because without this light on, the minis look really, really dull, and I wanted to light them up a little bit better and make them more dynamic looking. Yeah, so I totally smoke her. She is out of here. Ba-doom. And that
with your
means
roses?
With my roses, because they're all worth a point, because I assigned them to Axe Fist. So I get Juan the points, Shazing as Captain Cesare. So now the score is 3-2. Plus, I'm now carrying around two Cashman goodies for when I finally meet the king and then ask him for prizes. All right, this is going pretty well. So it's back to you. You get to move the factions and then draw a card.
Okay.
Who's moving first? Wait, you're going to move the Atlanteans first? Okay.
It's just the Atlanteans? Oh, no, I guess it's...
No, you got French, too.
Could he move and kill her?
No, because he's peaceful.
Right.
Oh, but he's got somebody on him. So there is one French guy on the board. He's just on the Tarasque.
Hmm. So does that mean that they would fight or not fight?
Well, it's kind of like you move... If you decide to move the French faction, the Tarasque moves first.
Mm-hmm.
So he can kind of like almost like slingshot characters into other C zones that they couldn't otherwise reach. Because the French guy who's standing on him right now, who's on this little town, he only has one movement point. But you move the Tarasque first. So let's say like the French guy could never reach this C zone with his one movement point. But if you move the Tarasque first and then he jumps out, now he's gone effectively two spaces.
Mm.
Right?
I see.
Yeah. Remember, she's stronger than he is.
Yeah.
And he wants to go... Where's
ports.
The weakest port? Yeah, so if you move him, Thieves Landing is already taken by the French. 6, 6, 10, 7. So he's going to want to go up to Nassau unless you move closer,
yeah.
And then he's going to want to go to Port Royal. So if you move move down to Tortuga...
That's strong, though.
What's that?
That's a strong port, though.
No. If you move the Tarasque down to Tortuga,
yeah.
And then move the French guy, the next thing he's going to want to grab is Port Royal, because that's the next closest... port that he can defeat.
Mm-hmm.
He'll put a thing on Port Royal.
Mm-hmm.
Where'd my sea sounds go? I might have to turn my sea sounds back on. He'll put a flag on Port Royal, but then she can, on her way to trying to wound the king, can swoop through here and beat him up and take him off the map.
Do we want her to do that?
I mean, it takes a bad guy off the map. He gets a flag, though. That's the bummer about it.
No. He's going to get a flag anyway, though.
He's going to get a flag anyway, I think. Because if you move her first, she moves down here, and then you can make him...
Here.
Yeah, he'll go up there towards Nassau.
Yeah.
And he won't get a flag. He'll stay on the map, but he won't get a flag.
Perfect.
You want to do that?
Yeah.
Okay, so... French guy hops out and... Oh, no, he will get a flag. He'll go up here.
That's fine. Whatever. Put him up there.
But if he goes down here, he gets a flag and he gets his butt kicked.
He's money.
Oh, you want him as money?
I do want him as money.
Okay. So he's up here.
Yep.
All right. She's made her decision.
I'm going to fight everything.
Here's a flag. That's not usually your gaming style.
No, all right. It's not.
So he puts a flag up there, and the Tarrasque gets even stronger and closer to being angry.
Well,
so that's what happens with that.
It's going to happen anyway.
So now you can move the... but at least we'd have one less French person to worry about. So you move her down there, yep, and mm-hmm. now you draw an event card.
And she has to move, too.
Oh, she has to move. I didn't even realize she was there. So you have a choice of moving her here or here. Top one?
Yeah.
Okay, there she goes. Okay, cool.
No, would I? No.
No?
She's going to take the shortest path, though.
How many C-zones? 1, 2, 3, 4. What's the shortest path? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, it's got to be this one.
Yeah.
That's the closest one. Okay. What is the event card? Did you peek at it
before? No, I started to flip it. It's silly, and I didn't look.
Cheating. Oh my gosh, what is it?
It's Spanish.
Spanish. So the Spanish gets stronger.
What?
Galleon's at 6.
Yeah, okay. So.
And what else happens?
We place the Spanish galleon on the board.
Okay. In a C-zone?
Yep. Uh-huh. And then next round, the reward for the Spanish is increased by 5.
Okay, so we can note that. Oh, you know what we missed?
No.
The Seekers have 2 movement points, remember? The Seekers have 2 movement points in this round. Uh-oh, that's bad. So she's going to go even further.
And she gets to him.
And she gets to him, right. So what happens when the Seekers finally reach this king who they've been trying to kill the entire time? Well, here's what happens. Yeah, she stabs him, and there's 3 wound spots for King Alaron. And unfortunately, he gets 1 wound. He can take up to 3 wounds, but once he gets wounded 3 times, he dies, and the Atlantean usurpers win the game. So the other thing that happens is she gets bounced off the board.
Oh,
so
like the fish, like...
Well, she
tail flaps her, and
she wastes. I don't know what happened. You can invent the story in your head, but she wasted so much energy stabbing him.
Well, I think he,
Well, but unfortunately, he's off camera, so we can't see the amazing.
I can show.
Okay, yeah, do it. Oh my gosh, that's incredible!
Kicked her out.
I think you're right. I think that's exactly what happened. I think the next one though, he's gonna eat the usurper and spit her spear out. That'd be pretty cool.
Oh dear.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
So we've moved the faction, we've drawn the event card, it's my turn again. I just want to move that Tarrasque out of the way. So really, the responsible thing to do...
Is to kill her. But are you responsible?
They're really tough now.
I know.
Where did the Spanish galleon go? You didn't put one on the map.
Oh, I forgot to put it on.
Oh my gosh.
He goes in the sea region, he's weak.
Just any sea region. It's not that weak. Yeah. Okay.
No?
Yeah.
No.
Going up there?
Yeah.
He is a 5?
Yeah.
Well, that is absolutely irresistible. What are you doing? No way. You can't do that. I'm totally gonna, because he's worth an extra 5 gold, so I'm totally gonna kick his butt.
I don't like any of this.
Well,
nope.
Tough. I think I need a tea. I'm going to get a kid to make me a tea.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Call in a kid favor. So I get 3 bonus dice for my ship, 2 bonus dice for Axe Fist, and I'm not tapping anybody else. I just have to beat a 5, though, so this should be a piece of cake. A piece of cake. 1, 2, 3, 4, and I just need 1 more. But I have 2 daggers, so the first ability on my rival activates, which cancels out a strength. It's very sad. So if that happens, let's put these up here for the moment. And I get 2 captain dice. This doesn't count because my rival's only at level 1. So I gotta get to 5. For every rose assigned, gain 1 strength, says Axe Fist. So that's 4. Uh-oh. I might not have been able to do it. I have these 2... Hold on, wait. I got 1 crew left. Where's the crew guy that I don't like? The Charming Rogue. Exhaust to gain 1 bonus die for each nemesis ability you've unlocked. Ugh, it's too late for that. I've already rolled. Crumbs. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign these 2 dice to Cesare to draw 1 crew card for each, and I hire whoever I end up with. So this crew member might save my bacon. Let's see. Pass me 2 crew members, please.
2?
Yes. This might do it. Let's Let's see. Okay. We've got the scullion or the bosun. Exhaust to change up to 3 roses into hits. Well, I don't have any roses to change into hits. Huh. Well, I mean, this is already what Axe Fist does, even though he's worth more money, and the higher the crew value, the closer you are to getting a point. But I think I'll take the bosun anyway. Exhaust to gain 2 bonus dice, if I remember to use him. So yeah, chuck this guy, I'll keep him, and I don't actually defeat... Let's see who I'm kicking out here. Oh, wait. Oh, I should have exhausted my quartermaster, I could have done it. Oh, that was foolish. I could have won this battle. Oh, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb.
Not dumb.
Yeah, it's foolish. I'm not paying attention to my cards enough. Okay, so I'll kick him out, and I'll take the bosun instead, and quartermaster goes away, and I feel silly. So what happens when you lose a fight? Well, I only did that to demonstrate to people what does happen when you lose a fight. That's the only reason I arranged the dice like that. What happens when you lose a fight is nothing. You just kind of waste your turn. So don't suffer any penalties from this Spanish galleon or anything like that. And it is... Have you ordered your tea yet?
I have tried, but I don't think I am able to...
From live stream service.
I don't think I'm able to raise a child to...
to summon a tea?
Oh!
Is that R-A-I-S-E a child or R-A-Z-E a child?
How much is one milk... And one sugar? Asks the child.
It's a great question. How much is one milk and one sugar?
I'm not a barista.
You know what? If I don't eat some chips right now, something bad's going to happen. So don't mind me. Very quick snack break.
Maybe I have asked the wrong child.
Surreptitiously eat chips on the stream. Nothing's so happening. Loud. I know. Nothing's happening. Whew. Crazy glue in chip packages now.
What is happening to your pirate ship?
See if I can eat them off camera.
All right, so I'm here not eating I am. Chips. I am right next to the king. And... That was very loud. Ack my ears, someone. Yeah. Okay.
Death.
Yes, they spotted my TARDIS phone case.
The crunching or the opening? Oh, let's see. Lovely.
It's a gift from Cassie when she went to Fan Expo. Just super awesome. Okay, so I want to give the king my goods.
Yeah, good idea. So to speak. So you go over there and you cash it in. Giving the king your goods, I mean, carry on. Not my wife in the game, do whatever you're gonna do. Okay, so okay.
Yeah.
So you pass him that token. It's hard to get it on camera because the corner is a bit off camera.
Okay, so here he is.
Yeah, what happened? Does he eat it? I don't know.
I don't know. Like, does the fish go nom nom nom?
I think so. So
yeah,
he eats it.
I think the fish eats it.
Okay, and then we go fishing through the deck. And you get to take any piece of treasure that says it's from the vault on it. So it'll say it's from the vault at the top left. All right.
Where does it say that? Like,
maybe we can do it on camera.
Okay. That's so exciting. I don't see anything that says vault. Is it in the title?
It'll say... Keep going. King's
vault.
Yeah,
relic.
There you go.
Okay.
So this means, because Cheryl is getting a relic, this means Cheryl earns another point. Wow, even Steven's on that score. I think we're a lot better at this game than we used to be.
Oh, definitely.
Let's just throw a point over on your captain. There you go.
Okay, so I'm going to put these away, and these are the choices.
I'm discussing milk and sugar. I base it on what you get at a restaurant. One milk is one of those little cuppies. One sugar is one packet worth. Either way, about a teaspoon. Pretty good. Nice and scientific. Hey, Omelette's back.
Yay, Omelette!
Omelette, the score is 3-3.
Here. So
the king has suffered one wound.
I can choose from this.
Okay. I'm eating chips.
Or this.
Uh-huh.
Or this. Or this. So, if you can read
that's
that.
A lot of choice.
Yeah.
Those are clearly cod pieces, but dumb tish. Very good. Very good fish jokes. Love it. Which treasure would you choose if you were Cheryl? In fact, maybe we'll put it to a vote and force you to choose what chat picks. No? Okay, keep reading. I don't know. There's a timer on this.
There is?
We can't think forever.
Okay, well, what does chat think? What's the coolest?
Well, you gotta tell them what they do.
Okay, so here's the Kingsworn's Trident. And I can gain a bonus die, and once per challenge, I can assign 2 ship's wheels to draw 1 tavern card, and then keep the drawn card. Which is cool. The next one is the Mantle. I can gain 1 bonus die, and once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to draw a tavern. Isn't that the same thing? Yeah. This one, though, is different. Gain a bonus die, and once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to move 1 seeker 1 region away from King Alarin.
So you can repel the seekers.
Yep. This one allows me to gain a movement, and when in a sea region, once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to refresh all of my crew.
Oh, that's pretty good.
That one's pretty rad.
Varys suggests you go with the giant fork because we're approaching dinner time.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, giant fork it is.
It's near dinner time after all. All right.
Voluntold. All right.
So this goes...
somewhere in that mess. Now, did you enter Claw Bay?
Yeah, I did.
And do you have a Claw Bay rumor?
I do.
Flip that rumor. Rumor confirmed. What piece of loot did you just get? The handy hook. What does it do?
I got gain 1 bonus die, gain an additional bonus die while in a region with a hiring hall. Cool.
So remember that, and because of that, Cheryl gets 1 more point. Ba-ding! So, yay. Chuck that on your captain.
You don't refresh your crew for giving him loot, right?
No, that's just a free action. It has nothing to do with...
Got it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, back to me.
That's my turn.
Yeah, it was a failure of a turn. Mm-hmm.
She's about to bounce over and stab him, isn't she?
Where is she? She doesn't have 2 movement points anymore. That was just for that one round. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm just trying to think if I can get anybody to fight anybody. Because what happens if we... hold on. One... he's down here, right? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. No, she can't go up there. 1, 2, 3. She has to go here. So she's going there whether we like it or not.
Refresh, renew, renew.
Refresh. What did we miss? What did we miss?
I asked if I could refresh with getting my king loot, but...
what?
Is that
why? Oh, refresh your crew?
Yeah.
You're going to have to use more than one word in chat that doesn't start with RE if you want us to know what you're talking about. We'll wait till the lag catches up and they can tell us what they're actually trying to say.
Yeah. Cool.
Okay. So I don't see any situation where this guy doesn't just totally attack me. So I think that happens. So, and I don't want it to happen, but it's about to happen. I'm just trying to think of where I want to bounce to. I think I will bounce to... I mean, you could bounce me into here, and then... no, that's bad. So, that's silly. Who would do that? Let's bounce me here, and then the penalty for getting attacked by him is he... does that... oh, you know what I just noticed? 6 money, 3 money is 9 money, plus 4 money is 13 money, so it is not actually... oh, thank you very much for the what did I miss? I was in the middle of... it's a gift! Thank you for the gift! Who gave the gift? I can't... Duskin, thank you so much for the community sub! Yeah. Thank you, appreciate that. I don't know how those work, maybe you can tell me. What I was about to say is I get a point because I have 10 bucks worth of crew. Da-da-da-da-da-da! How many bucks worth of crew do you have? Let's count up your crew value.
7.
So you're not quite there. Okay, no. Right. Back to it. Right, but I just exhausted a crew member because the spend... yay, banks and pots. That's right. Oh, Logan's Run joke. Oh, deep cut. The only... Can you quote any Logan's Run?
No.
Fresh fish from the sea. I think that and run, runner. I think those are the only two I can do. Yeah, okay. All right.
I only remember the runner.
Run, runner. We say that around the house every once in a while. Yeah. Whenever anybody's like in their underwear and trying to catch the macaroni before it burns. Run, runner. that happens more than you're going to admit, I'm sure.
No, that was more like... Send Izzy upstairs to get something.
Yes. Run, runner. Yeah. Back to it. Nerds, I think that was a nerdy sojourn.
Yeah.
Okay, so the Spanish are done. We have the Atlanteans and the French left. I was hoping that I could maybe move the Tarrasque down to put the Atlantean on the Tarrasque and then later move the Tarrasque away to make the Atlantean further away from the fish. You see what I'm saying? But I don't think I'm going to be able to do that. I don't think I can. But what I can do... Oh, no. I was going to say I could get the French guy onto the Tarrasque and move him away, but... Hold on. Let me think. But I can't. The French guy's going to go in here no matter what happens, and the Tarrasque has to move one away. So where do we want the Tarrasque to go? I don't know. I don't think it matters. I'll move the Tarrasque down here. There's the Tarrasque noise. And he wants to go towards the next... So he can either go next cheapest. Still is point. Up there. It's definitely that one. Though, I think it's the... Hold on. Let me just double check, because I think
he only gets one movement point?
Yeah, he only gets one.
So just move him to the next sea region closest.
Well,
to
but hold on. Port. Nearest non-French port whose strength they equal or exceed. So I have a choice. Because here's a nearest non-French port... Whose strength they equal or exceed. Let me get a little bit closer on that. That's worth the second. Oh, he already has it. So, no, it's going to be that one for sure.
Yes.
You're right. Okay, so the French have moved, and now the Atlanteans are going to move. And the Atlanteans, as we said, go down here. So it's basically murder her, or we're two hits down towards losing.
Yep.
Two hits out of three.
Yep.
Two strikes. And I can't reach her.
Do it.
I can't reach her. And sure all can. My crew is exhausted.
Sure you can.
I can't reach her. All my crew is exhausted. Your crew isn't exhausted. You can reach her. So I am going to go drinking. Pull a card for me.
Oh my goodness.
I think that's what I'm doing. Where are all my adventure tokens? They're everywhere, eh? They're all in that corner where stuff is happening, and I don't want to go anywhere near.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I'm going drinking.
I'm going drinking.
It's your job. It's your job to fight the Atlanteans. Forget it.
Cool. How about you move over here?
Hold on. I'm just triple checking. No, I have nothing to give me extra movement. Oh, these come with me.
Nah, the British get them. Or the Spanish.
Do the Spanish get them? I might have to check on that.
Why would they get them?
Well, you can lose tokens that you're carrying around. I might have to check on that. If Guildhall's still paying attention, maybe they can refresh my memory about what happens to those items. I'll look them up when it's your turn.
But I think they come with you.
I'll look it up in a sec. Okay, am I going drinking is the big question. Because I can't
marker as usual. Cheryl does all the work.
Well, I can't do anything effective over here. The only thing I can do is try to go back up and kill him.
Which doesn't help us.
No, because he's going to start getting rid of these flags eventually. Yeah. But he's only at level 5, so he can't get rid of that flag. Mm-hmm. Unless we draw a Spanish card. And who's to say we're going to do that?
Are you sure he's only level 5? We've only drawn... Yeah.
Only drawn one. Yeah. Yeah, so he won't be able to take those on.
Okay.
So tell you what, I'll make you a deal. I'll take out the Spanish guy if you take out... Here, put this drinking card back.
Don't take out the Spanish!
Why?
Because they can take out the ports eventually.
Okay, going drinking. arm wrestling. You crush the competition. Of course I do. I'm Cesare. Cesare is a good arm wrestler.
With Axe Fist.
Axe Fist was really doing the work that whole time.
Yeah.
So I'm going to get 4 gold, 4, and 2 more, 6. Axe Fist still pines for a giant harpoon he spotted in San Juan. So if I make it to San Juan, I will get the giant harpoon. Where's San Juan, you ask? Why, it's right here. Have I moved yet? No, I haven't. Will I? Yes, I will. Where will I go? San Juan. And what happens? Oh, look, I discover the giant harpoon. Yes, and what does the giant harpoon do for me? Well, first of all, it's a relic, so that gets me a point. Ba-doing. Yes.
What are the score odds is of that? 5-4.
I don't know. Probably 1 in 8. And what else happens? Gain 1 bonus die. You may challenge a captain or NPC in an adjacent region. I can shoot from a distance. Pretty good. Pull them into your region. I can harpoon people. I've never had that item. That's amazing. Okay, it's your turn.
Okay, cool.
Yep.
All I can do.
You gotta go fight her.
And it's, I don't really... My crew is half...
It's the only way.
My best crew. And I still have my... Yeah, it's bad. Okay. You've left it for me.
Okay.
I get those 4. I get 3 for my ship. I get 1 for my trident. And that is all.
That's all you get? Oh. Really?
Yeah, really.
Search your heart and your cards.
Oh, my relic gives me an additional bonus die, and 1 additional bonus die while in a region with a hiring hall.
Are you in a region with a hiring hall? No, you're not. You're in a region with a buried treasure.
Yeah.
With a hideout.
So I get 1. Yes,
tea has arrived in the chat. You have to yell like Scorpion in Mortal Kombat, get over here! I will. I'll try to remember. Oh, thank you for setting a marker on it. I appreciate that.
Thank you so much, Iz.
All right. So, I don't know. Chat, do you think this is... do you think this battle's going to go well? It's possible. Like, you could get 2, 4, 6, 8 right on native captain dice and totally smoke her. I'm worried about this rival situation.
But... Oh, so am I. I usually don't roll daggers, but I rolled nothing but daggers this game.
All right.
Here we go.
Looking bleak.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Ooh, that's really bad.
Yep.
It's really, really, really bad.
Yep, it's about as bad as it could be.
That's a rough roll.
Yep.
So what's... Oh, dear. What's happening? Okay. So you have all 3 rival powers unlocked, so all 3 of those things are going to happen. So you lose money. I don't mean to laugh.
You're totally laughing.
No, I'm not laughing. I'm not really happy about it. Pirate chuckling. That's all that's happening. Okay.
I only have 1 rose.
Yes.
And these are strength, but that doesn't count.
The dagger only cancels out 1 strength, right? That's just your first rival's ability, right?
It cancels out 1 strength, yes. The next one is if I roll 2 or more, lose 3... three gold for every captain's wheel rolled.
Accio T says Oberon. Old Ryra is going to be sleeping with the fishes tonight. In the fish house.
Yeah, he's walking the plank to the couch.
What happened with those 2 captain dice? I wasn't paying attention.
So these could be strength, but I can't.
Why can't you?
What's the point?
What do you mean?
I don't defeat her at all.
Oh. No, you come nowhere near defeating her.
And if I roll 3 daggers or more, I discard an item or a relic.
So you have to decide... Wait. Do you have to discard money as well?
Oh yeah, I lose 6 money and a relic.
That's really bad.
So...
That's really, really
are
bad.
Are you actually laughing?
I'm not. No, I'm crying. That's awful. It's awful for that to have happened to you. I'm so sorry.
And, yeah.
Ooh. Okay.
You could stop laughing
right now.
I'm not
laughing.
You're totally laughing, and I don't appreciate it.
I'm breathing jollily. Okay, so because Cheryl loses a relic, she also loses a point. So now the score is 5-3, which looks like it's good for old Rai. However, it's not looking good in the Caribbean because the Atlantean usurpers are about to deal their second death blow to the king. Didn't I move the bad guys last time? Am I getting confused? Or did I?
You can't do that in the middle of a turn.
No, like, what happened? I'm just wondering if I forgot to pass this on. That's all that happened. I did forget to pass it on.
You did. I agree.
Okay, so I took my turn out of order, but that's not a big deal. No. So I did a turn, you did a turn, and now you move the bad guys, right? Uh-huh. Okay. You don't seem happy about it. Just drink that tea. Drink that tea and get back to us when you're ready.
I'm salty. Okay, so my dude's here.
This is a semi-compassionate live play.
She...
Yes, it's about as compassionate as it is cooperative.
Stabs him.
She does. Oh, well, he... No. Well, he... Yes. He moves... Wait. If you were to move the Atlantean usurper faction first, the fish would move first. That's the first thing you gotta know.
And he time, why wouldn't he have moved?
Because he was already backed in a corner. Now he's got an option. He can either move here or he can move here, because that's to get away from the usurper.
She can still get him.
She can. I'm just wondering, does it do anything if we put the fish on the Tarrasque? I think it does, because we'll have...
He only has one movement point.
Right. But it would put him out of her reach. Okay, so watch. This is the cool part of the game. This is the part that I think is really neat. The puzzle of the bad guy moving. And I'm quarterbacking a little bit, I'll admit. But check this out. Move the French first. And within the French faction, the Tarrasque has to move first. And when you move the Tarrasque, move it towards the fish. Yes. Now move the other French guy. He's going to go up to that port. So we're getting sort of like scary on the French, but
yep.
Here, let's put a flag up here for a French guy. We'll deal with the French in a second. We're dealing with this Atlantean situation. Now move the Atlanteans. So the fish moves onto the Tarrasque. Does that do anything? I thought that did something. And she fights him on the Tarrasque. So no, that does nothing. But at least he's on the Tarrasque.
Why?
Because that lets us... Yeah, it does nothing. Does nothing. Darn. Yeah, that doesn't do anything. She's going to stab him no matter what, right? And he's going to take over that port no matter what. I don't think there's anything we can do about that. So, okay, let's deal a sad second blow to King Alaron. One more and we have lost the game to
right the Atlanteans. In the fish mouth.
Right, that's where he takes it. That's right. Sad, and it's very sad now there are no more Atlanteans. I can cash in my treasures. Great. And they don't go there because they're not strong enough. They go to me. No, they go to me. Yeah, they go to me. Okay. I think they go to me. Hold on, let me check their nearest non-Spanish port. Port with whose strength is equal or exceed. Yes. Their strength is 5. No, there aren't any non-Spanish ports. Oh, there are. I think they want to go for the port before they go for me. I could be wrong about that. But that is a Spanish port with a strength... A non-Spanish port with a strength that equal or exceed. So they're going that way. So I think they go here. Mm-mm. You think they avoid that because they can't beat it up? They only move cautiously when there's actual pieces for them to avoid. I think they'll just bulldoze past a port. That doesn't matter to them.
Really?
They just don't fight the port. They're trying to get to that port.
Alright.
I think that's what happens. I hope it doesn't happen that they attack me, because they want the port first, not me. If that port wasn't there, then they'd absolutely attack me.
Yes, Omelette, the Spanish are still strength 5.
Yeah, Spanish are still really weak. But let's flip an event card and see what the Spanish do.
Yeah. Oh, it's a
Spanish card. Okay. So what happens? The Spanish go up one notch.
Yep.
So now the Spanish are strength 6. What else happens?
Place another Spanish galleon in this region.
Uh-huh.
And then they're 6 now?
Yep.
6. So then next round the reward for them goes up by 5.
Okay.
So I can place them... He's going to go up there to take that out. All right, to place it here now, right?
Well, who's going to go up where to take it? What out?
This guy would bounce into there and take that out.
Yeah, he wants
to. Oh, but the soldier's there.
It doesn't matter. The French guy's going to move down to... How strong are the French guys? They are 6. So he's going to want to go to... Where's the closest six? Like, he's going to want to go down here to five. Right. Oh, no, to Port Royal. That's a six.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Mm. Okay. 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 So, passez-moi le. Okay, great. And now, my turn in the correct order.
The Tarrasque is neutral, yes. It's not enraged yet.
Yeah, so far it's still neutral.
But who knows for how long?
Like, what I'd like to do is take over a French port, but I'd have to fight him first. I'd have to fight him first, and then I'd have to spend a second turn. Yeah, I could do it. Then he's worth more money. I should have gotten rid of all my extra movement stuff.
You did?
Yeah, I can't go fast anymore. Okay, I'm gonna fight the Spanish. I think that's okay. So I get four, I get three for my ship, I get two for Axe Fist, and now I'm gonna very carefully read my actual crew cards. Bosun exhaust to get two bonus dice. So I'm gonna get two more bonus dice. Probably don't need them. Oh, you know what? I can pull him to me. Does that do anything? Pulling him to me? I can use my harpoon. And I don't think that does anything.
If you pull him, that means you get movement points after.
Yeah, and I can move farther.
Yeah.
I was in San Juan, but he's not adjacent to me from San Juan, so I'd have to move at least one, and then I can't move the other because I've interrupted it with a challenge.
Mm-hmm.
But at least, yeah, I like that. Yeah, so I'm going to pull him down. Okay, so my relic lets me gain a bonus die. Hold on, wait. To recap, four captain dice, three for my ship, two for Axe Fist, two for my bosun, and one more for the giant harpoon. It feels like too many, but whatever, let's do it.
If the Spanish was there, wouldn't they remove that flag? If they're six?
Not on the turn that they moved, because they were moved, five, right? When they moved
in. Yeah.
Okay. I can't see me being unsuccessful here, but stranger things have happened in the Caribbean. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's nice to see. 9, 10. It's nice to see the numbers I'm getting now. This is a strength. But then this dagger takes away a strength. And this lets me draw a crew and hire it if I want to. So throw me a crew member, please. And the crew member I get is the Cannoneer. Exhaust to change up to three captain dice into ones. Well, that's pretty good. Who should I get rid of? Do I have any zeros? Yeah, I'm going to get rid of the gunner just so I can have a refreshed crew member. Sorry, gunner. Yeah, she's a better version of the gunner, I guess. Okay. So, results. I kill the Spanish. I get 5 gold plus another 7 because they were worth bonus gold this round. I'll put another 5 gold on there in case you want to kill the other guy. So I get the monies, and that is it.
You done?
Yes, that's it. Okay.
1, 2, and I'm doing a rival adventure because I cannot.
He's just gonna remove that flag if you don't fight him. Yeah, you're right on it. So you're taking an adventure?
Uh-huh.
We haven't done an adventure in hours.
Yeah.
I forget how to even do it. Okay. What kind of adventure are you taking?
It's a rival one because I cannot afford to lose more relics.
It looks like a lover adventure to me. Oh, a rival up there. Okay, cool. So this one, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And everybody can see, I hope. Just double checking. Yes, we're good. Okay, here we go. You barrel through the Spanish jail and finally spot the cell you've been searching for. You quickly pick the lock and throw open the door. Maru! Oh, your voice. Maru! You shout. The cell's only occupant, a pale woman attempting to squeeze her hands out of her bonds, raises her head. Poor timing, as always, Tun. Jules sneers. You missed your muscle-brained idiot. Oh, you just missed your muscle-brained idiot. She gives a menacing smile. She must be having real good fun with the Spanish right about now. Jules grins playfully. Tell you what, set me free. I'll help you find your precious, salty savage. Oh, she's not very nice. Accept Jules's offer, or find Maru yourself. I don't know if I'd trust Jules.
No, I'm going to find Maru myself.
Okay.
Because she's the worst.
Rot in hell, Jules, you sneer, storming away as you heft your massive stone sword into your hands. You're not exactly graceful, Tun, Jules calls after you. I hope the doom of the sea does you in. And that's capitalized, so that's important. Fortunately, it only takes a few minutes for you to locate the interrogation room, where two Spanish guardsmen are busy strapping Maru to the rack. You drive your sword upward in a rising arc, dropping the first guard, and bring down your blade with a mighty crash, felling the second. I like the writing here, too. It's not, like, super gory, but you know what's going on, but it's written in such a way that, you know, it describes what you'd be seeing, like, a swashbuckling movie kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, somebody swings a sword and a guy falls down. Not, like, guts splurred out through the nostrils. Anyway, Kaloi Maui, Ton, Maru shouts as you free her. She holds you close. Is Jules
still locked up? Though I'm sure she'll escape soon enough, you reply. Let's head to Smuggler's Cove. I want to find one of Jules' former crew, a deserter with a loose tongue, and get some answers about the capital doom of the capital C.
The results, which is all you care about. Remove Jules' last ability, that's great. Gain 4 gold, and then Smuggler's Cove is where your thing goes next. Mm-hmm. So, remove an ability, you got the gold, and Smuggler's Cove up here in the top corner. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Good, good, good. Okay.
Excellent.
The fish is on the Tarrasque. Mm-hmm. The Tarrasque is approaching angry. The Spanish are up there. The Spanish don't want to go anywhere near. Oh, I know the best thing to do. The Spanish are 6.
Yeah, so they can take out the lower ports now.
Yeah, so they can take out the 6 ports. But why wouldn't they conveniently go to this one and mess you up a little bit as well? So you have to exhaust a crew member. This is the game. This is how we play. So exhaust a crew member and then decide where you're going to flee. Mm-hmm. Oh, that was a bit rough. Easy now.
Okay. Can't reach.
And then we're going to remove this flag. Mm-hmm. And interestingly, the flags don't go back to the supply. They go back onto the Tarrasque carts. The Tarrasque gets a little bit more calm, thank goodness. And I think we can do even better with that. So that was the Spanish's move, right? There's no other Spanish on the board because I fought the other one. Great. Okay, next, either the Atlanteans or the French. I'm gonna go French and move him down here because I want treasure. And then I'm going to move the French guy. He's at level, at strength, what is he at now, 6? So the nearest 6 that is taken is here in Port Royal. So 1, 2, 1, 2, so you can go to either of these. So I'm going to make him go here. Great. And now you get the first player marker, and it's your turn. Here's the score, just to keep everybody up to date on what's happening. That's 5-3, so that's 5 points for me. 3 points for Cheryl. And 5, interestingly, is a higher number than 3. So it means
if I beat you up, can I take your tokens?
You can take one of them.
How do you know it's one?
I believe it's one, but I'll double check for you. What's it called? Well, like, you couldn't beat me up and take all my relics, right? So you can't take all my tokens either. All right.
Let me just. What's your crew look like?
What's my crew look like? You can't take a crew member.
No, I know. They're all exhausted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Except for one, the cannoneer that gets me 9 dice.
Mm-hmm.
Great. The results of a player versus player battle is the winner either takes half of the defeated player's gold rounded down or chooses a defeated player's item, one of items, relics, or faction objective tokens of which that upon.
Mm-hmm.
One.
Yep.
One.
You guys should try it.
I mean, don't you have better things to do? Don't you want to go kill that French guy instead? The Spanish guy is worth... Oh no, he's not anymore. He's not worth any extra money. Flee to Tortuga and then attack Ryan, says Omelette. Omelette wants you to attack Ryan.
Yep.
Ryan doesn't want it to happen. You really think you can take me on? I'm rolling so many bones.
How many are you rolling right
now? I'm rolling almost too many bones. I'm rolling... Okay.
All your people are exhausted, so...
They are exhausted,
so tell me how many.
I'll tell you how many. I would be rolling 4 dice to begin with.
Yep.
Then I would be rolling...
Your ship, yeah.
3
so
more for
same
my
as
ship.
Mine.
Then I would be rolling 2 more for Axe Fist. Then I would probably opt to... I would use my harpoon for 1. Mm-hmm. And I think that's all I got.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's all I got. But my cannoneer, I could exhaust to change ship's wheels into hits. What do you think? Is it worth it? What are you rolling? What do you get? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I get 10 dice. I get 10 dice. What are you rolling against 10 dice? You're rolling 7 and then what else?
I didn't do this part last time. I should have, but whatever.
What'd you miss?
Once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels
mm-hmm.
and draw a tavern card and then keep the drawn card.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did you have the ship's wheels to do that last time?
Yeah, I got the bonus die and then I didn't do this because I was too worried about losing some gold for my ship's wheel. Remember
right,
that devastating,
right.
devastating
Silver says, kill him!
Yeah.
I don't know, guys. I got 10 dice is all I'm saying. I got 10.
Okay, I have...
Uh-huh. Count it up. 4, 7, and then what extra? Your crew's all exhausted, too. What are you talking about, exhausted crew? Look at
I've
you.
I've got 1.
Look at you. They're all asleep on the below decks.
And then I got this stuff.
Yeah, you also have the rival stuff. It could go very bad for you. Ver says, he be bluffing. Run Ryan through.
Okay, I just have to do what chat wants, Ryan.
I think you do. I think you do. Chat wants blood.
It's probably going to go terribly for
all
me.
Right.
And this is not how I usually play, but...
No, it's not how I usually play.
You and, started it?
And we'll see why this is not how Cheryl usually plays. Okay, let's go. Let's go. It's dice time. Let's do it. Send him to the bottom of the briny deep, says Omelette.
So that's for my ship,
uh-huh.
and then 1 for my trident.
Are you only rolling 8 dice? 8 dice to my 10? Is that what... That's what you're coming at me with? Okay. All right. I won't count. Play your own game. You're a big pirate. Let's do it. I love to psych her out like this. Especially with PvP stuff. She does not like it at all. We played an entire game.
No, I'm just like aghast at your... condescending nature.
We played an entire game of Dead Reckoning and nobody shot a single cannon round. Alright, let's see how it goes. Ooh, I don't know, Cotton. looking pretty anemic. Looking pretty low. A lot of swords dropped over the side of the ship. A lot of pirates tangled up in the ropes and falling down.
Are you done yet?
No, I haven't even begun. All right. I just try to add color commentary to make it interesting. I'll stuff my mouth with chips instead.
Oh, I should have gained a bonus die against a follower, right? Like that lady that I...
Yeah. Yeah. I know. I'm missing dice too. I'm not paying enough attention. It's hard on stream. It's hard. Streaming ain't easy.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Maru and the Gambler says, just can't get those roses.
Yes.
Is that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Two bonus roses for three strength.
Yep.
Blue rose with Gambler for two strength.
Exactly.
Five strength from three roses. So this
is five. And then six and then seven for tons. And then eight, nine.
What is happening?
And then ten. And then I lose one, so nine. So.
Hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Hold my beer.
Cool. Not gonna happen.
I'm rolling 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All of this for a lousy token?
Yeah. This is payback. This is pirate payback.
I don't know, man. I don't know. Here, let me get the shot up.
You did. You took me down for 4 goals.
I did.
How lame was that?
That was the beginning of the game, though, so I think it was worth it. Beginning of the game, 4 gold meant a lot. Now, I mean, come on, you're just being petty. Doesn't look good. 1, 2, 3. Wait a second. Ooh, that's bad news. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I gotta beat 10? Holy crap. Oh, monkey. 3 daggers. Terrible.
Gamblers.
3 daggers.
And I lose all my gold, by the way.
3 daggers and it... Oh, you lose all your gold because you rolled daggers?
My rival thing.
3 daggers. One of these daggers cancels a hit and the other two don't matter. This will let me draw a crew member and the rose, which could save me. I don't know. And the rose is another... no, it's not. Yeah, it is. What did I say this was?
I don't know. I can't see with your hand.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is my Hail Mary pass. It's not looking good. But I'm going to use this and assign it to Cesare to draw one crew member. I hope it's changed roses into nines. Let's see what it is. The drunker... exhaust to change a dagger into A1.
Yeah, that's pretty cheap.
That's garbage. What if I did it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Does the drunkard actually do anything for me? Hold on. I mean, I could get rid of this loser who is only worth 3.
How much is 9 bigger than a 5?
Yeah, 9 would be. 9 would be, except that... Hold on. 4, 9, 10. I'm just at 19 with the crew. I will get rid of him. All right, you done it. You bested me. So you get, what do you want? Do you want half my gold? Do you want one of my tokens that I'm about to take to the king?
How much gold you got?
I didn't even move him. He's here now.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. I've got an amount of gold. I've got some sum of gold. I've got a sum of gold. I've got an amount of gold. It's more than 0. Yeah.
Booty.
I've got 10, 15. That's chip money. 15, 18. I got 18 gold. Do you want 9 gold?
I think some people say that you did move him, by the way.
Oh, no, I moved him. He was, correct me if I'm wrong, he was on the Tarrasque. The Tarrasque moved, and then he further gets to move. So I moved him to where I am.
I think.
Yes. I don't even need to hear your answer, because I know what's happening. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I think I want that 9 gold, babe.
It's yours.
No.
Awful. Yeah. Awful outcome.
Yeah. No, it's the right outcome. Mm-hmm.
Can the NPCs get on the Tarrasque? Yes, they can. Anything that's on the Tarrasque's sea zone is on the Tarrasque. So when you move the Tarrasque, it's moving everything. Except for flags. It's not moving flags. It, like, blots over. No, take the trophy, says Duskint.
Really? Because that's a point for
him? It is a point. It is a point.
But he's also going to get a point if he gets a ship. And he's really close to getting a ship.
Mm-hmm.
He's 2 gold away. Oh, right. That's 2 points.
You only get one of them. You only get one. You don't get both trophies. You only get one.
I know, but...
But it is 2 points if you let me hang on to them.
Yeah. And then you get...
Trophy gets you a relic. And the relic can do things for you.
You want the gold back.
I kinda do.
Okay, it's okay. Up to you. Anyone else in chat? Anyone else in chat? Gold or relic? Gold or relic. King is in your region. Cash immediately. I know.
Oh, thank you. You don't have the choice, is what he's saying.
I don't?
No, because I moved the king into my region. Are you sure it's not when I enter the king's region? It's a free action. I think it has to happen on my turn. Let me check.
No, mm-hmm. It happened on my turn. That was, I used a turn.
No. Like, on my turn, I moved the Atlanteans into my region, and Duskint is suggesting that in doing that, I immediately cash them in, but I believe I have to cash them in on my turn. But let me just look it up. Let me look it up. So I haven't encountered that.
No, there's... I'm saying Cheryl can cash in right after combat.
Correct, because it's a free action. Yeah, so if you grab them, you can cash them right in and get the thing. You don't have to... Because he's there. Okay, she's giving me the money. Okay.
Gobble, gobble.
he eats it, because that's in her head kind of now. And... You get to go to the Atlantean Usurper's deck.
Which is right here.
You got it. Okay. Can you grab all the ones? Because I'm going to have to pick next.
Yeah.
Okay. Good counseling, chat. Thanks.
That sounds sarcastic.
No.
Is that sarcastic?
No, if you read the transcript back, you'll see us. I'm very sincere. Okay, throw it on camera so we can see what's up. Camera.
Mm.
All right.
I think I'm going to take this one.
Well, what were the options? Maybe chat can weigh in on that.
Well, I mean, they already saw them. They're the same ones. Right? These are the same.
Walk me through them, because I'm going to be picking next.
Once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to move 1 seeker, 1 region away from the king. Meh.
Eh. We'll regret that later, but yeah, go on.
The trident, which I already have.
Which does what?
Once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to draw a tavern card. Oh. Did I have 2 ship's wheels? No, I had lots of roses.
Okay, next.
Once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to draw a tavern card and keep the rumor or the item.
Okay. There's always assigned 2 ship's wheels?
Yeah, and then once in a sea region, once per challenge, assign 2 ship's wheels to refresh all crew.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Let me look at my crew, because my crew might be... Just change as soon. No, gain 2 bonus. No. Okay. Good. Okay. I want the third one you talked about. No, the one before that. The one that gives you a relic or an item or a rumor. Yeah, okay. So, my turn. I cash in the token. Delicioso. And then...
Now he's Dora? Okay, cool.
Okay, just to update the scores. So, I get a point for having a relic, and you get a point for having a relic. So, now we're at 6-4. Very good. This is a meaty game, man. We didn't die right away, which is pretty good. Cool. And I have the potential of getting more relics through that relic. I love it. Mm-hmm. And now I actually get to take my turn. Mm-hmm. And I can take on the Spanish and kill them, as I've done before, with my harpoon, without even moving, and then I can move. How strong is that French guy? 6, eh? He's 6.
But you don't have refreshed
crew. I don't have refreshed crew. What I should really do is go drinking. How much money do I have? We established I have 19?
18.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Why do I only have 13? 10? Oh, no. Because I can't count. That's why. 18.
Ryan does math.
And it costs 20 to get the thing. Okay, what I'm going to do then... Oh, the choice is clear. The choice is clear. I'm going to go drinking. Yep. Yep.
You drunkard.
Hand me a beer. And I'll tell you why I'm going drinking, because it'll get me at least $2. I think you can always count on at least $2 from a tavern card. It'll get me a rumor, maybe an item. And so with that, I'll have the money I need, if Cheryl doesn't beat me up for it, to do something with that money. Okay.
Beat you.
Okay. Dirty Limerick Challenge. There once was a man from Pitts's fence. Okay, alright, here we go. Your shameless rhyme wins this time. Gain 5 gold or increase your lover's level. Oh, wait a second. Oh, wait. Happy accident. For every 2 assigned, gain 3 strength. No. I need the money. I'm gonna go for the money.
That's a pretty good lover's level. You should probably take that.
I'm gonna need go for the money, and the rumor puts me in Nassau later. So I take the... How much money? 5 gold? Okay, 5 gold. Wait. I got it. Yep, no, it's good. And then I get to move, because I, believe it or not, still haven't moved yet. So I'm moving up to Smuggler's Cove. And that's my turn. And now you get to move the thing. And while you move the thing, I'm going to... entreat everyone to a musical interlude.
What?
You heard me.
Okay, what am I moving first? The Tarrasque?
You decide.
Doesn't the Tarrasque? No, the guy puts the flags on them. Shouldn't this have a flag?
He is not strong enough, I don't think. He's only 6.
So the Tarrasque will move, I don't know, here. He'll move here, and a flag gets put here.
I'm not paying attention.
You're about to be really loud in my ear.
I'm going to be really loud. What if I'm quiet, accordion?
No. He's not going to bounce me.
What? I wasn't even paying attention. What happened?
He's going to go here.
So, the Tarrasque moved down. He moved up there.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants to take out that port, which he does, right?
Mm.
Oh, where was he? He was at Thieves Landing?
Oh, yeah, you're right. So he would go up here.
Well, he can't go 2, though.
No, you're right. He can't go 2, so I moved him here.
Yeah, he's there. You're right. You're correct.
Yeah. Okay, fine. I did it right. What are you doing?
I'm playing a sea shanty. Go. No? French flag on Port Royal.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he is correct. French flag on Port Royal. So we put one back, but then we lose one again.
Yep.
Oh no, we didn't even put one back. We just lose one. I'll sing you a song, with a song of the sea to me. Way, blow. What's going on?
Next?
Okay, yeah. Cheryl won't let me sing sea shanties.
You can sing shanties. So, okay. We're increasing the level of the Spanish. What are they now? Still 6 or 7 now?
Lower men down, boys from Liverpool town. Give us some time to blow the man down. Blow the man down, hey, blow the man down, way, way, hey. That doesn't let me have any fun.
I do too.
All right. What's the question? clearly, the Sea of Legends question is more important than a musical interlude. What's going on?
We're increasing the level of Spanish. I'm asking you what level the Spanish are currently.
The Spanish are currently at level 7, so it's going to do all 3 things in the card, which is going to be pretty bad for both of us.
Increase your nemesis level.
I don't want to.
Yeah, well, you gotta.
Accordions are heavy. Okay, she's at level 2. I don't like it. Thanks, I hate it. And what else? Actually. It does the other. It does the first two things as well, the six and the six. So is that, what, two more Spanish on there? What does it do?
The reward for the Spanish is increased by 5.
Yep.
And increase your nemesis level.
Okay. And it places one too, right? Yeah, it places Spanish Galleon in the sea region.
I did.
Oh, where did it go?
Right here.
Oh my gosh. No, that's where he moved from here. No? Maybe this one is the one you placed.
Mm.
Yeah, he moved from here to here.
You're right. Then I put the other guy. Okay.
All right. Are we having fun yet? Okay.
Okay.
All right. All right. I am first player. All right, we're doing this. We're doing this. What's the score again? As he sneaks another chip. Do you want some chips? Is that the problem? You don't have any chips? I can give you some chips. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Yar.
Yar. I remember what I'm doing. This Spanish guy's going to take out that flag. That Spanish guy's going to take out that flag.
Did you just learn how to play that today?
Yeah, why?
Okay, I'm just curious.
Didn't it seem like I learned how to play it just today?
No.
Okay. Great. So, with all of that happening, I am very excited to announce that I'm in the market for a new ship. So, I'm going to spend, well, it's 20 bucks, right? 5, 10, 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is the first time in this game I have ever been able to afford the third ship. Pass me the deck of triple ships. Class 3 sailing vessels. Oh, a finer piece of boat you've never seen. Now, the class 3 ships have different stats on them. So let's just evaluate them and maybe chat. If you think there's one that I should definitely buy, you can let me know. I'm going to try to make it not blurry. All right. Whoa. I'm trying to mutt. We got the Iron Wind, we got the Widowmaker, we got the El Toro, we got the Swordfish, we got the Tricord, and we've got the Folkestone. Okay, so the stats are four cannons, six cannons, two sails, three sails. So if you go up in cannons, you're not going up in sails, right? And everybody can take four crew except for Folkestone can take six crew. And my guy's ability is crew. So I would love a combination of crew and cannons would be the nicest thing. However, this is the only guy who lets me have six crew. So I think because of that, that's the guy I need to take.
There's two fish that let you have two crew. Or two. Two boats.
Two fish.
I am tired. I need food. That's
4, 2, 6. Look, chips. We got chips. Sneak some chips. They'll never know. Yeah, 4, 2, 6, 4, 2, 6. 64, 64. Oh, okay. So they're in pairs. So this one's the same as this one. And this one's the same as this one. And this one's the same as this one. So there's really three choices of ship. And in a multiplayer game, they'll, you know, fewer because they'll take the boats, possibly. So I think I should take the Folkestone. And doing that, take all these. Hopefully I didn't mess anything up too badly underneath. There you go, back into the deck. Because I took a tavern action, all of my crew are refreshed. I love it. And then the next thing that happens is the back to the scores. I get two more points. 1, 2, I'm now at 8 points because that ship, mighty ship, is worth 2 more points.
Disgusting.
So it looks like 4, again, I'm not good at math, but I think 4 is half of 8. And that looks pretty good to me. All right. However, the Tarrasque threatens to freak out. Which shipyard did I go to? Are you calling me on a discount? I went up here to this shipyard. Read him and weep. He's like, no, you didn't. Yes, I did. That's the shipyard I went to. I don't know. Is he going to say something? I'm going to wait, because Das Kint might be like, oh, when you go to that shipyard, you have to take 3 punches to the face. There we go. I needed a map. Okay, yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, so I went out. Because I did a bunch of stuff down here without even moving. So I did all my stuff, and then I moved, and then on this turn, I did the shipyard stuff.
Wait.
Have I not moved yet? What?
Actually...
What?
I don't think you did stuff, and then you moved, and then you did stuff. I think you can only do stuff once.
I took a free action down here.
How?
The free action was to give him my trophy and collect the piece of treasure from him. That's free.
Didn't you do a tavern action and refresh your crew? Am I wrong?
Yeah, I did. And then I moved up here, and that was the end of my turn. So I tossed in the token, I went drinking, and then I moved up here. That was my turn. Then, while I was messing with the accordion, you finished it up by moving all the factions.
Oh, then you went.
Passed the token.
You went.
Now it's my turn. We're good. And now it's your turn. So we're good. We're caught up.
Okay, it's fine.
No, I didn't take a tavern card on the same turn. The tavern card was last turn while Cheryl was still first player.
Yeah.
So now Cheryl's second player. Cheryl takes her turn. We're good. We got it. Three punches to the face. Well, how is it still punches to the face? I was trying to avoid the whole punch to the face the entire time. Okay.
Well, I mean.
You can tell when it's dinner time and we lose everybody.
I'm losing myself. Okay.
That's fine. This is going to be rerun on YouTube and people can watch at their leisure whenever it's convenient for them. But they don't get spoken to. Hello, I see you, Das Kind. Das Kind is German for the kind. I know kind is child. I don't know what kind is.
Mm.
What is kind? What happens when you add a T to kind? Does it turn it into the murderer? I don't know. You
child? That's Varys, isn't it?
Yeah, Varys says child. I'm asking the German guy, not Varys. Come on now.
Okay. So, I don't even know what I want to do anymore. How strong are the French?
Six.
Right. No, I need to refresh my people. And I really, really hate my nemesis. Because she makes my life evil. So let's just go there.
It's adventure time.
It's adventure time.
Adventure time.
Tell me a story, Ryan.
Well, I'll tell you. Tell you a song, boys. A song of the sea. So you're going to your nemesis adventure up here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You have to check a few taverns, but you finally find one of Jules's former crew, a deserter known for drinking and his loose tongue. You strike up a conversation with him. He's happy to tell you whatever you want to know, until you mention the doom of the sea, and then he freezes up. I see this going one of two ways, Maru remarks to you. We can ply him with drink until he thaws, or you can just buy his loyalty. So, you can either drink the poor sod under the table, or pay him for the information.
I have no money.
For a cost of 4 gold. Well, looks like you're drinking!
Drinking him under the table.
You keep the rum flowing and steer the conversation to how terrible Jules is. And then she just sailed away laughing while the orphanage burned to the ground, says Maru, finishing her story. At least
Jules can never do anything worse, you point out.
At this, the drunken pickpocket bursts into tears.
Yes, she can, she cries. She means to use a magical idol to waken a primordial horror and use it to destroy anyone who opposes her.
We're missing a quotation mark in there. Suddenly the deserter grabs your arm.
Go to Havana. Stop her before it's too late.
Results. Maru will remember this favor. Remove Jules's last ability. Let's catch that on camera. All right, cool.
Yeah.
Draw 3 crew. You get one for free. You get an item from the tavern deck, and your nemesis adventure token goes in Havana. So let's see your 3 crew choices first. I'll move your nemesis adventure token into Havana. What do you got?
I'm going to take the bard.
Bard's great. I love him.
I think.
Well, he'll
give me 3 dice.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
That's the best one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so I'm going to replace my gunner. These are all exhausted, and he gets that way.
Now, you also get an item from the tavern deck.
Right, and I get an item, so let's see. That's a relic. 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 Relic.
Oh, interesting. It's to help Americans not pronounce it as kind. The
item.
T at the end, kind, I see. My parents called me the kid before they decided a name. Oh, that's fun.
Aw.
I love the stories behind people's usernames when they're interesting.
It's great.
All right, what'd you get for an item?
I got the whale blubber.
The whale blubber is very good.
Yeah.
So you can deflect an attack, right?
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Yeah, that's they came neat. In handy last game we played. And a notoriety for your crew worth greater than 10.
Yes.
Nice. Thank you. Good reminder. So, 8-5. She's chasing me, but man, I don't know. It's looking good. It's looking good for old Rai-Rai. Looking good. Okay, so I'm going to move the factions, and it's looking good for old Caribbean, too, because this guy goes over here and gets rid of this flag, and then this guy goes over here and gets rid of this flag, and that is the Spanish turn done. So we're going to put these flags back up here. I think that's what happens. Yeah, that's what happens. The Tarasca gets calmer. We don't usually play this long. This is a long game.
Yeah,
but we're getting there. We're almost there. We're almost there.
Are we?
We I'm are. Hungry. I know. And then French is going to go towards Claw Bay. They're going to take one of those flags off and put it on Claw Bay. But the Tarasque moves first. Let's say the Tarasque moved first and the Tarasque moved to... it's dangerous to put him closer to Tortuga because that's where he wins when he gets mad. But let's put him closer to Tortuga. And then we'll draw... Oh, and then these guys go. So I'm going to move him over here. Great. And the French Empire increased the level of the musketeers, so they get tougher, down to 7. They're as tough as they can possibly get. One musketeer and the Spanish galleons are worth more money. Oh, that okay. is already on there. And one musketeer. So 3 musketeers. 3 musketeers. And your nemesis level goes up.
It's like a cruel joke.
Yeah, that's very bad. Well, let's get those musketeers out there. Da-da-do-da-do-do. Wa-da-do. It's just in a sea region, right? An empty sea region. I like the idea of having them near the Spanish so the Spanish can take care of the messes they make. So we'll do that. No, you know what? I also like the idea of killing the Spanish now. We'll do that. We'll do this. And we'll do... Yeah, down here. Okay, cool. All right, pass it on. You're up.
No! Okay. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. I know why it's so quiet. Somehow my soothing sounds have run out. Here, we'll do one that has a little bit of music in it. One, two. Are you doing a lover adventure?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let me get over there.
I'm going to do the tavern. And then go kick some butt.
Wow, what's it going to be?
What are the French worth again?
7 gold, or you defeat the port that the French had taken over.
Right. Okay. Yeah, lover adventure. Why not?
Whoopsie-daisy. Here we go. Lover adventure on Tortuga, yes. You're trudging through a cave in Tortuga, following a haphazard trail of sprockets. Eventually, you enter a large chamber with a giant orrery. The planet, you know what orrery is? Hmm. Remember the Dark Crystal, where they had that big solar system model in...
Yep.
Yeah, that's an orrery. The planets are the size of men, fashioned from gold, silver, and other precious metals. By Davy Jones's locker, your first mate, Caramala, says, leaning against the miniature Jupiter. You hear a very loud click as it moves 6 inches along its orbit. It's a puzzle, says Maru. We must align the planets in some way. Caramala taps her foot. Ugh, we can solve it. So it's a challenge 7 to solve the puzzle, or forget the puzzle, strip this thing of its precious metals. What do you want to do? Can you do a challenge 7?
Oh, my nemesis ability is at 3 again, and that is...
Hmm. We could let chat decide.
I'll do it.
Oh, she's going to try to solve it for a challenge 7?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Challenge 7, challenge 7. Get 4 dice. That's the start. Then you get 3 dice, because that's your ship. Then you get what?
And then I get a bonus die for my relic.
Yep.
And then I get... Am I close to him? No. And then I get... I can exhaust him to gain a bonus die for each lover ability I've unlocked, which is 3.
Whew. Mm-hmm.
And then that's it.
This feels like the big climax. I think you're going to fall in love after this, right?
Yeah, definitely.
It's looking pretty good.
Oh, no daggers. Looking pretty good. One dagger. That's okay.
Looks good.
One dagger gives 1 strength. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This would be a 7.
And then 2 roses to do whatever you'd like with.
That could be strength. It doesn't even matter.
So you just win, right?
I just win.
Okay, let's go back to the app.
Yeah.
Okay. Did you successfully solve the puzzle? Do you have anything else to declare before we go on? Money or bonuses or perks or anything? Whatever, you succeeded.
No, I succeeded.
You succeeded. You nod slowly as your face splits into a devious grin, your eyes widening with excitement. And Karamala sighs. If the stars are aligned like that, he says, pointing at small holes in the ceiling, then we need to move to Mercury and Venus. Oh, then we need to move to Mercury and Venus, you finish. He pushes Venus. Well, now I'm wondering if you're getting their pronouns mixed up. Because isn't Karamala a she? Interesting. So that might be another bug in the app.
Or it doesn't matter.
He pushes Venus while Maru shoves Mercury into place. That should do it. Oh, no, that should do it, you say. The Earth lowers to eye level and spins so that the Caribbean is facing the sun. You realize that Tortuga is actually a drawer. It pops open, revealing an obsidian jawbone with matching teeth. Kaloi Maui, Maru goes pale. It's definitely from the Derelax Maw. You scratch your head. Oh, come on, Ton. You know, that super dangerous sea cave filled with treasure and obsidian teeth? In Nassau? Never been? Let's fix that. Unlock Maru's next ability. Gain 16 gold! And Lover Adventure Token goes to Nassau. Holy monkey! That's lots.
Mm-hmm.
That's a whole lot.
Mm-hmm. True love. I get a...
Did it say true love?
I get true love because I used an item to push it up higher, so the app doesn't know that I did that.
Oh, and it was Nassau that you're going to?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, wow. So you gained true love. So up to the scoreboard, did you take the point? So you're at 6 points?
Yep.
Ooh, 8-6. All right, it's anyone's game at this point. All right, take the dice back.
Mm-hmm.
Now it is my turn. Oh, and I'm going to get into some trouble now. It's just gold for defeating those guys. 1, 2. Wish I could go farther. Nassau? Yeah, that's what I'm doing. That's definitely what I'm doing. So, I'm traveling to Nassau, and the very first thing that happens is I confirm this rumor, because there's a golden spyglass. Once per turn, you may look at the top card of the crew tavern and event deck. Nice. And that, back to the scoreboard, gives me 1 point. I'm at 9 points now, Cheryl. 9 points. 1 point to win. 1 point to win. Here we go. And I'm going to I'm going to challenge that Spanish galleon. All right. They're at 7. And they're worth an extra $5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, here we go. I'm rolling 4 for my ship. This is going to be absurd. Okay, 4 for my ship.
Yes.
4 for my ship.
As you said.
I'm just thinking, like, should I fight Tortuga instead and get 2 points and win the game? No. I'll do it this way. 4 for my ship.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get a bonus die for my harpoon, a bonus die for my mantle. I'm going to get a exhaust to gain 1 bonus die for each lover ability, so 2 more bonus dice. He gets me... Axe Fist gets me 2 more. for his big immune ability. I'm going to exhaust Dumas to get one bonus die for every two musketeers in play. I don't know. This is getting silly at this point. And I might as well... I don't know. That's enough, right? No, I'm going to exhaust my bosun to get two more bonus dice. Okay, that's almost all of the dice in the entire game. So I'm going to roll these, and if I don't beat it, that's it. Somehow the stream will turn itself off. Okay, here we go. You can't take a free action until the hostile is gone. Oh, who is the... Oh, okay, yeah, you're right. I have to defeat him, you're absolutely right, and then take the free action to get the relic, but I think I've got a pretty good chance. So here we go. Rolling all the dice. Almost all the dice. Oh, this is hung up, so let's roll it again. It's a one anyway. Yeah, I do it. Let me just see what these daggers are doing here, though. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Because there's extra stuff that happens. Oh my gosh. So... My strength so far is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. But I could get extra bonusy things.
What's his strength?
His strength is 7.
So you did it.
But wait, but there's more. So I got all three rival abilities unlocked. Mm-hmm. So... This would take away strength. I'm just going to name them out because they might not happen. Take away strength. If you roll two or more, lose 3 gold for every captain's die roll. I'm going to mitigate that. And then if you roll 3 or more, discard your most expensive crew. So nuts to any of that. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to exhaust my drunkard to change one of those things into a 1. So back to here. That's now a 1. So I only have 2 of them to deal with. No, 3. It's still 3. What did I just change into? Did I have 4 daggers? Really? Seriously? That's garbage. Hold on.
I couldn't see because you keep putting your hand in the way. Sorry about that.
Up to... exhaust to change up to 3 cannon dice into 1s. 1, 2, 3... Okay, so these are now all, well, one, I don't really need numbers, I need to not have this happen. Yeah, so I won't exhaust her. Wow, I've got like almost too much strength.
But yes. Do you lose something if you have 3 daggers?
Yeah, I do, that's the point. If you roll 3 or more daggers, discard your most expensive crew. So I'm going to lose a point doing that. That's what I'm going to try.
I see.
And if you roll 2... I see. So she says if you roll 2 or more daggers, lose 3 gold for every ship's wheel rolled.
That's
so
my
that's
problem.
What that's going to help. So I turn the cannoneer so that these aren't going to be ship's wheels anymore. These are going to be 1s. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Great. That's why I got to do that. This... is going to become a 1, but I think I'm going to have to discard my most valuable crew member, which is garbage. My most expensive crew. So, shoot, that takes me down a peg. Who's my most expensive one? 5, 5, 6, the bard. The bard is going plunk, kersplash overboard. That's very sad. And now my crew is worth 1 less point, and so I go down a point from 9 to 8, right?
Mm-hmm.
But at the very least, at least I killed this Spanish guy. Draw 3 crew and hope you get someone that can handle those daggers for you. Yeah, I thought about it, but that's mega risk, and I don't know if I like that idea. But it's a good plan. I could have done that. You're right. I could have done that. But I didn't. I'm going to take 5, 7 gold plus another 5 because there's a extra bounty on them, so I got a big pile of gold, and that's my turn. So it's time to move the factions. Mm-hmm. I swear, we're almost good. We're almost done. Mm-hmm. Okay, move the factions time. Who's moving first?
Is there only 1 Spanish?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Weird. Okay.
Spanish are at level 7, and the musketeers are at level 7, so that Spanish guy can, if you move the Spanish first, will take out that musketeer, which I think is a pretty good idea.
Okay.
Boom, out of there.
Oh, no!
Oh no! The fish is hooked.
Okay. And then I guess the fish will go up here.
Yep.
And this guy will... No, he won't stay, right? This guy's going to go down here for sure.
Yep, to Cartagena.
I'll put a flag on that.
Yep, flag on Cartagena.
Well, this guy will stay and guard it?
No, he wants to go up to Havana.
So he's going to go up there.
Yep, and that's everybody. Well, oh, no, there's one guy over here.
The Tarrasque is going
to
move.
Oh, the Tarrasque is supposed to move first, but...
No. Oh, does he move? Can I do this?
He moves wherever you want him to.
Sure.
Okay.
That guy's going to go up to Smuggler's Cove, right? And put a flag on it?
So here's the Tarrasque situation. It's looking not great.
Dire.
Pretty dire.
Somebody gonna take it apart or what?
Well, let's see. Let's see if we can eke out a win here.
And I need to flip cards, but there's none left.
Okay. The galleon should have gone down to Port Royal for the French flag. You're right. So let's put this French guy back here.
What should have?
Oh. He should have gone towards here. So we could do it the other way, and we can make the French guy, French move first and take out the Spanish, but I don't think we want that to happen, do we? But that means that the French guy is going to go over here, and we'll only have one flag left if that happens.
Is the Tarrasque enraged now?
He is one flag away from being enraged.
Right, well, doesn't the skull point... Oh, okay, now he's one flag away.
Yeah. So we put a new flag up there. Thank you for the correction.
I can't take it apart. I am too weak right now. Okay. So, it is the Atlantean usurpers.
They're at level 8.
So.
We put 3 of them on the board, don't we?
One seeker in the region as far away as possible from him.
Mm-hmm.
One seeker as far away as possible.
They don't like the same port. In a C zone or anywhere?
C. Oh, yeah. C. Sea
this
region.
Is as far away as possible without being... Oh, no, this is... Okay.
Okay, and then next round, they gain 1 movement point.
And do our rivals go up?
No.
Okay.
Oh, next round, yeah, each player increases an emphasis level. Mine's already the top.
Well, I'm at the max, too. Okay, cool.
Yep.
All right. So did you just hand this over to me?
No. I never toss it over to you.
Then why did you move them? Oh, maybe I took it from you. That sounds good.
Probably took it. Yeah, you're the one moving it back and forth.
Okay.
So.
Because you had a move, right? I did my thing where I took out the Spanish, and you did what?
I started, didn't I?
What did you do?
A lover adventure.
Yes, you're right. Okay. Okay. The question is, with the score looking like it is... I'm back down to 8, aren't I? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm at 8, right? Because I was at 9?
Yeah.
Well, I think I can easily audit my points, can I not? I have 1, 2, 3 in these things. 1, 2, 3. 1 for my ship. 2 for my other ship. 4, 5, 6. 1 for my crew. 7.
You got points for killing...
Oh, yeah.
...usurpers.
How many?
You got 2, because you got 2 trophies.
8, 9. So I should be at... No, I can't be at 9. Really? Yeah, I got 2 trophies. So, hold on. Maybe I am at 9. So I just need 1 point to win. Right?
But...
What?
I took a trophy.
Doesn't matter. I earned the point for the kill, not the trophy.
Yes, correct.
Okay. Well then. The good news is, the game is over.
You won?
I won because I'm up in Nassau and I can bury... Whoops. I can bury... Come on now. Yo! I can bury 10 of my gold and get the point for that and win.
Okay.
Yay!
Congrats.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we did it. We played an entire game of Sea of Legends. Usually not that long, but games take way longer on stream than they do in real life.
They really do, for generally. Sure. Reason.
That's the game. Usually we do like a quick little like, what did you think of the game? But we have played this game
a lot.
Many times, because we adore this game.
It's
and
a great game.
Hopefully you can see why. I don't know if any of that was entertaining for you, but I just find they're just interesting decisions to make throughout the game. Nothing like super brain melty, so it's not like a big Euro game. It's, I think, you know, it's an American made, it's a Seattle company who made the game. I just, the reasons I like it are, I just find it just oozes personality. I find the writing is very, it's very fun, and I feel the writing's very light. We played another story-based game that we all universally despised. You hated it, I hated it, all of our friends hated it, everybody we've shown hated it. And part of the reason is that the writing isn't fun, it isn't breezy, it's very stuffy and uses 10-cent words to a 2-cent effect.
That's only part of
it. There's so many reasons, but this...
That's a video.
That's a whole video, and it's coming. It's coming in October. We'll be doing that.
I almost want to join that video.
For a certain mad science-themed game that shall remain nameless for the moment. But I just find, like, this is, like, it's silly, it's goofy, there's neat choices to make. It's definitely easier to teach the rules to people than Merchants and Marauders. It fixes a lot of the mechanical problems Merchants and Marauders has. As long as the app doesn't act up, and I think that we were pretty lucky this time without it doing anything
buggy.
We
were very lucky, yeah.
I think
we downloaded new content, so maybe fixes were made.
True. So did you back this? Are you planning to back it based on our recommendation? Please let me know. It's on Kickstarter right now. It's only out for 2 more days, and this is the third time they've kickstarted the game. They're on the second expansion, and the second expansion, oh man, am I excited about these expansions. The second expansion adds translucent ghost faction. I see if I can remember them all. It beefs up the Spanish faction, so it adds the Spanish Empire, so they're doing more stuff on the map. I think it's got like a conquistadora who's trying to like escape the Caribbean with like all the looted gold from the Aztecs that she's subjugated. So there's those guys. There's the new one that they just announced, which is basically like a Captain Ahab versus Moby Dick kind of thing with this gigantic whale mini. You gotta see it. I should have put a picture up, but It's like eating a boat. It's eating one of the Spanish galleons. It looks hilarious, right? So you got that one. You've got, can I think of the, oh, you got the French. And then the fifth one is the, it's killing me that I can't remember the fifth one. Maybe Dust Kent can remind me of the fifth one. The writhing maw. So you get like, yeah. So it's like the Kraken. So you get like this, like these tentacles that appear all over the map. Yes, and they suck you and they pull you in. And then there's like the big monster mouth that comes out and wants to eat everything. So come on, so cool.
That's
and
awesome.
How cool would this game look painted?
If you want to paint it so
go
badly.
Go Google it and look up some of the painted minis.
So badly.
They're awesome. Like, everything, I don't know. I just love it. I love it to death. It's awesome. I haven't, like I said, I haven't geeked out about this game, about a game like this in a very long time. I'm so excited. Look at his little skull on his belt. And the other cool thing is they hired this, you know what? We'll just go. Hopefully my mic works when we go to screen. This might break, but if it breaks, I'll fix it. Look, there's my desktop.
Oh, no.
All my things on the desktop. Just wait. Here, I'll move this over here. Now we're looking. This is good now. Okay. This is the campaign. Look at the numbers go up, Cheryl, as we recommend people go back in. No, so there's the gigantic whale mini.
Oh,
hilarious.
Wow.
Winters in Valriada, right? And it's eating in one of the boats, and he's got a big old harpoon, like I did in the game, right?
Yes.
And I got to show you a couple of other things here. So these are all the captains, right? I was going to show you the Bob Cal stuff. So they got this, I don't know, as famous as you can be as a pirate illustrator. He's a known pirate illustrator. So I'll scroll down to that part.
Wow.
And maybe I'll try to make it a little bit bigger here. So there's the Spanish Empire, like I told you. That is the Cursed Souls faction. So they're actually going to be translucent green. So they're kind of see-through. That's cool. The French Empire is the one we played with. We showed you. There's the Writhing Maw, all the tentacles.
Cool.
Excuse me, one of the stretch goals was to make the tentacles look all different. There is the Captain Ahab styled faction. That was the one that won the vote, so that's the one that everybody wanted. So there were other ones in there in the mix, like giant crabs. I voted for like a voodoo themed faction, and that's the one that that won out. What else we got? Right, so you add 4 new captains, and so they all look cool. They all kind of look like... This guy looks like the Ghost Pirate LeChuck, like, absolutely, right, from Monkey Island. But what I wanted to say... Hold on, I'm digging down to it. These are the the previous factions in the first expansion. So you got the Aztecs with Quetzalcoatl and like these Jaguar Guardians, and then Order Nocturnus is like a Lovecraftian themed faction. You've got the Sea Coven, who are now in translucent blue, so that's a witch who transforms you into a giant water bear, and she's got these water foxes. And you've got the Sentinels of Mokul, who are like monkeys who chase these fruits around a map that you can take and sell to a merchant, and so can the Spanish, but that makes the monkeys mad. They're trying to put it in their temple. Anyway, the Skystalkers, the Harpy wants to run around and capture her eggs, and she's got like a calm slash and rage thing like the Tarrasque does, but if you take her eggs, she gets really mad. She chases you around the map, and she's got like 3 movements, so she can like clear the whole map in a single go and kick your butt. The longer you manage to hang on to an egg, the more points it's worth. Super cool. So it's like a hot potato kind of thing, okay. Right? I'm almost getting down to the point that I was trying to make. So there's the 2 expansions plus the base game. So you can buy them singly, or you can buy the whole thing mm-hmm. altogether. This is the guy, the pirate illustrator. So most of his pirate, like, they're hot chicks, right? But I love this guy. I'm going to, like... Oh, I can't zoom in anymore, but I love this fat pirate. Look at this guy. It's like, yes, finally, I'm represented in a board game. So he's this big tub with a huge sword, and he's got, I can't remember. I think this is a dodo on his head. If I zoomed in, I would be able to see it. But they've all got, like, animals and stuff. But he's got, like, a hook hand, and he's got a peg leg, and he's peak pirate. I just love him to death. And then, like, a bunch of really sexy pirates. This guy's got, like, a falcon on his shoulder. I don't know. They're all cool. I think they're super cool. And these aren't unique. These pirates all have the same pirate powers as the existing captains. All these are just like a skin swap. So use the fat guy maybe in place of Cesare, or you know, one of the existing pirates. They got the same abilities, but different you know, cards for them. You can get metal coins. You can get the neoprene mat that you saw us playing with. The difference between the neoprene mat and the board that comes with the game is that the neoprene mat is larger, so you can fit more stuff on it. It's a little bit like what they did with Scythe. Not quite the same scale, but remember, you can't fit anything on Scythe until you get that big board extension. Mm-hmm. So that's the idea. They got metal notoriety coins. Oh my gosh, and these are all the stretch goals. Super cool, mega fun. I'm into it.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's amazing. Thank you so much for joining us. I don't know if anybody's left 10 people, but if you're watching this in rerun, thank you for getting this far and watching the whole thing. Since we're on Twitch right now, I'm just going to look up somebody that we can raid real quick so that I can dump all 10 of us into the next thing. You know what? As long as I've got my screen active, we can go shopping together for somebody to... Actually, no, it's on the other monitor, and I'm never going to be able to see that from here. Okay, so let me switch over. Still getting used to doing things like a grown-up.
What is that supposed to mean?
Oh, no, I just killed it. Maybe that's we won't raid somebody. Last time we tried to raid somebody at this time, there wasn't anybody.
Sorry for being a... No, not at all.
Sorry for being a what?
Backseat driver. No, we like it. We like having chat give us advice and...
Yeah, it's
tell
the best.
Tell us the best things to do.
Who's apologizing?
Duskint.
Duskint, you should apologize for apologizing. Hold on, let me just queue up Twitch real quick. Duskint, even, like, if you or anybody else who's still in chat wants us to go to a certain raid target, we will gladly raid those people. As long as they're not, like, ladies in bikinis and hot tubs, maybe we won't raid them. But you can find them on your own. Let me just see.
The board games...
Where are the board games?
At the top there? What's that? The board game. What's that all about? Board Game Garden.
Oh, is the Board Game Garden on right now? We like the Board Game Garden. Let's see. Let's just sit through an ad, and if the Board Game Garden is streaming, then we'll do it. I think so. So I'm gonna queue it up. Raid the The Board Game Garden. Yes, great suggestion. The Board Game Garden, it shall be.
Sorry for apologizing. You
exactly. You should be. All right, cool. We got the Board Game Garden queued up. Remember, when you jump in there, we got a special emoji for kicking over furniture. Please use that early and often.
Kick it all over.
We have to knock everything the heck down, or else how they know that we're here. Yeah. Thank you very much for joining us for this stream. Remember to back this game, because I'd love to see even more of it. I think it's cool and awesome. Thanks again for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.
Did you just watch that whole thing? Oh, hey, to 100% this video, click the badge to subscribe, and then click the bell to get notifications when I've got new stuff.